Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon to the afternoon session with Dr. Ravishankar Parvaje, sir. We welcome you, sir. Dr. Ravishankar Parvaje has BAMS from UP Ayurveda College in 1985 and completed his MS in Ayurveda from Basindu University in 1989. In November 1989, he started his profession as a surgeon and Ayurvedic physician in Puthu. In 1991, sir developed Pratisaraniya Kshara Karma and Agni Karma in different conditions like piles, fistula in anu, fissure in anu, rectal prolapse, pyroneural sinuses, carcinoma in situ, and non-healing ulcers. He established Sushruta Ayurveda Hospital in Puthur on July 2002 and till now, 1991 to 2012, done 8,000 cases of piles by Kshara Karma and Agni Karma. He has presented guest lectures in different seminars and different Ayurveda colleges on the subject of Kshara and Agni Karma and Rekta Moshna.
Hello, hello,
sir, we can hear you.
Hello,
hello,
hello, can you hear me? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Eh? Hello?
We can hear you. We can
yes,
hear
sir,
you.
Audible. Audible.
So should I start now?
Yes, sir.
Two more minutes to the session. 2:30.
Okay. Just to tell me when I should start. Okay.
Okay, sir. Definitely.
Namaskar for everybody.
Namaskaram, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. We will start with the afternoon sessions of the Emergency and Critical Care in Ayurveda seminar. I once again welcome Dr. Ravishankar Parvaje sir to talk on the topic Intensive Ayurvedic Stroke Management. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you very much. So, first of all, I am very thankful to organizers for giving this opportunity to share my experience of treating acute stroke by Ayurveda based on Karya Karana Siddhanta. Am I audible now? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Audible, okay. So first let us pray our Guru, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasme Shri Gurave Namaha, with the salutation to our all Adi Gurus, Apurva Vidyas and Apurva Vidyas. I will directly go to my presentation. It is Management of Acute Stroke by Ayurveda. So now here coming to what is acute stroke. Stroke means it may occur due to hemorrhage or occlusive by infarction or thrombosis or embolism. It may present as transient ischemic attack, Lachner infarct, infarction of anterior, middle, posterior cerebral artery. So evaluation stroke means patient comes with just a weakness to complete hemiplegia related to area involved, minor to major vessels involved, both in hemorrhage and infarction. So prognosis of a stroke is according to age, according to area involvement. Older age, bad prognosis, and big area, bad prognosis, small area involvement, and younger age, better prognosis. What happens in a stroke is, there is a small area, complete death of the tissue occurs. Complete death of a tissue occurs. Due to this dead tissue, there will be a big area of inflammatory swelling inside brain. So there will be a big area of congestion. So how much fast you treat, this one you can't treat, already gone case. This one, how much fast you reduce this inflammatory swelling, that much fast congestion also reduces. Patient walks out of the hospital. If you are not treating properly, what happens? This inflammation increases, then dead tissue also increases. A patient coming vertically to your hospital, he goes from the hospital horizontally. So this condition, treating this condition is very important. Correctly treating, that's very important. So result and presentation, how they present you in a clinic when you sitting in a hospital? They come with just disorientation or unconsciousness or coma. They come with convulsions, weak body, that is hemiplegia, or they may come with the death also. Usually there will be increased blood pressure, or there may be sometimes due to shock, there may be decreased blood pressure also. So blood pressure is not the criteria for diagnosing a stroke. These are all according to age and area of the involvement. What is the treatment? In hemorrhage, acute management, correlation, correction, electrolytes, IV fluid, RT feeding, Foley's scan, oxygen inhalation, these diuretics. These are all symptomatic treatment. There is no specific treatment. May recover, permanent, or may not recover. this is the treatment in a hemorrhage. In infarction, recently some drugs are developed, thrombolytic drugs. It should be given within 4 hours of attack. There is a definite will be patient will get relieved immediately. And then antiplatelet drugs, icosapent, etc., to prevent further attack. Then treatment of complications, seizures, electrolyte pneumonia. This is treating complications accordingly. Early passive movement, after stabilization, physiotherapy or rehabilitation. So a stroke means it may come with the, not only due to infarction hemorrhage, a stroke-like syndrome may come with the infections like tubercular nodule, abscess, encephalitis, a malignant growth, injury, like that they come. Or the treatment is, if it's infection, anti-infective treatment or surgical intervention. These are the treatment all told by me for Western system of medicine, the explanation and treatment. According to Ayurveda, how we should do this, we should think. So in Ayurveda, in Charaka, he says, Hetu linga ushadam jnanam swasthatara parayanam. Patient comes to us with the linga, signs and symptoms. That is, maybe one-sided weakness or convulsions, these are the linga. We have to find out its cause, why it has happened. See, according to medicine, okay, the cause, they will tell according to their concept. According to Ayurveda, if you are giving Ayurveda treatment management, we should understand what is the Hetu according to Ayurveda. Then Aushadha management should be given. So that means Charaka says the treatment should be given, the disease should be understood and treatment should be given on the basis of Karya Karana Siddhanta, cause and effect Siddhanta. Even Western medicine also developed on same assumption. The cause explained in the Western medicine biochemical activity, they're explaining derailment of biochemical activity, that is how cause is explained in Western system of medicine. In Ayurveda, we never understand a physiology or pathology disease process according to biochemical activity, a molecular activity. We understand whole body according to Tridosha Siddhanta. That is why Sushruta says, Nasti rogo vina doshai yasmat asma vichakshana anuktam api doshanam linge vyadhim pacharet. There is no roga without doshas. So that means any roga means you have to analyze the dosha. The another meaning of same shloka is Nasti aroga vina dosha. When doshas are in samavasta, there will be aroga. When doshas are in vishamavasta, there will be roga. Anuktam api, even it is not told, you have to see doshanam lingaihi. In Vyadhi, you have to see doshana linga, then you should treat the case. If told in textbook, you have to do doshana linga in a given patient. Then you have to give the treatment as a dosha vyadhi viparita chikitsa. That is why, how it happens. That is Charaka says, etu sthana vishesha dhavetu roga visheshaha. A specific vyadhi, vishesha means specificity. Specific vyadhi will occur according to hetu vishesha and according to sthana vishesha. What is hetu vishesha? Hetu vishesha means hetu vishesha pittavaranadi. Yatha madushti, madosha dushti, hetu vishesha. Yatha dosha dushti, is it pittavarana, is it kafavarana, is it raktavarana, yatha. That is hetu vishesha. Sthana vishesha, yatra sthana samsheha. Koshtagata, sandhigata, like that, he is told. In the context of Pakshaghata or stroke, he said the sthana vishesha is tiryagadhamani urdhva dehaga. Now let us analyze first sthana vishesha analysis, then we have to do hetu vishesha analysis. We have to do. So Pakshaghata, usually stroke we call it as Pakshaghata. Hatvaikam artha dakshamavacha. What is Vakshagata means? One-sided weakness, right or left side. That is Vakshagata. That is a linga. What is Hetu? Just to give, a patient comes with Vakshagata means giving some treatment is not treatment. That becomes symptomatic treatment. It is a symptom, a sign, Vakshagata. One-sided weakness. The Hetu Vishesha, that we have to see. First Sthana Vishesha, then Hetu Vishesha. What is sthana vishesha? In Pakshaga, sthana vishesha is adodagama sa tiryagadamani urdhva dehaga. In tiryagadamani in urdhva dehaga, in that area, when Prakupita Matarishya, Prakupita Matarishya means Vata Dosha, gets Sansamsha Tiryagatam Gurdu Dehaka, you get Anyatara Sandhi Baddhankars, you get a Pakshagata. This is the sthana according to sthana shesha of Pakshagata. Or you can have Akshepaka also. Again and again, Sansamsha release, there will be maybe Akshepaka. Akshepaka means convulsions. One is Akshepaka, second one is Pakshagata. These two diseases can occur when Tiryagatam in Urdu Deyaga is sthana samshaya occurs, according to sthana samshaya. So, how many types of Pakshagata is there? This question arises. Usually, when I ask these questions to the most of the students, they tell Pakshagata is Vataja, only one. Or somebody may tell Avrajana and Dhatukshayajana. But actually, Sushruta says it is actually five types. What is that? Shuddha vata hatam paksham krita sadhyatam vidu sadhyam anya sansrutam asadhyam kshaya hetukam. One is shuddha vataja. Second three is anya dosha samsrishtaja. And fourth one is kshaya hetukam. Here question comes, what do you mean by shuddha vataja and kshaya hetukam? Because by the adukshaya only vata prakopa occurs. Then Jayajata says, shuddha vata hatam paksha. Jayajata says kshaya hetuka means it is kevala vataja only, but here kshaya dhatu kshayaja means he says shonita atisruti krita dhatu kshayajam. When external bleeding is there all from body, when in time of Sushruta there was war was going on, cutting of the limbs, all this. Nowadays road traffic accident occurs, severe external bleeding occurs due to hypoxemia blood, there will be global hypoxia in the brain and the patient will go to cerebrovascular accident state, semi-conscious, one-sided weakness, all these things occur. When this happens, he says it is asadhya. That vata prakoja is asadhya. But balavad vigrahadito viruddhahara vihara krita rakta dushti rakta anvata prakopa getting sansamshayat tiragdam urdo dehaga, that is kevala vataja. That is kritir sadhya. Then what is sulabha sadhya is anyadosham srishtaja. Leave these two things. Anyadosham srishta means what? Pitta samanvita, kapha samanvita, both kapha, pitta samanvita. This is sulabha sadhya, he said. When this type of stroke is sulabha sadhya, we should treat it. Why we should leave such a case? We should refer to a Western medicine hospital. It is told in Sushruta that it is sulabha sadhya. That asadhya, okay, you leave it, send the refer the case to a appropriate hospital. When this pitta kapha samanvita, he is told it is sulabha sadhya. Then we have to understand what is pitta kapha samanvita. For that, for a pitta samanvita, Bhava Prakasha says dasantapa murcha sivayo pitta samanviti shaitya shodha gurutvam tasmineva kapha vrti. When pitta samanvita is there, he says patient will have daha, santapa and murcha will be there. And ye kaphasa manu, there will be shota, gurutva, heaviness, saimitya, these things. If you see acute stroke just after an attack, if you comes to your hospital, if you see, they either come with coma or come with unconsciousness or come with the semi-conscious state. This state they come. That indicates patient having a stroke, one-sided weakness, but with these symptoms. That indicates a pitta samanvaya. Or some patient comes with numbness and a tingling sensation, heaviness in one side of the body with the weakness on the part of it. That is kapha samanvaya. When this, usually most of the patient of stroke due to infarction, hemorrhage, they come with these signs and symptoms. When this indicates, this is nothing but a pakshagata occurred due to vata prakopa, due to kapha or pitta samanvita. Pitta or kapha samanvita. When this, he said it is sulabha sadhya, we should treat it, you know, we should live such cases. Now let us analyze, since it is a murcha, is the pitta samanvita acute state. Now we have to analyze what is a murcha. Murcha again, when they come with the murcha or coma, we can't make out dosha predominance, but they come in madha stage. Initially, they come in madha stage, semi-conscious stage. This madha is four types again. This is vataja, pitta, kaphaja, sannibhataja. This we can diagnose. A vataja will be askalit, irrelevant, speed, irrelevant movement will be there. Pittaja, krodha, purushabhashyam. You will be have krodha and purushabhashyam. The kafaja, sarpa, sambandha vachana. Less speaking and asambandha vachana. The pittaja, then he will be, he spit on you, hit on you. Prahara kalipriyam, they will, if you see the cases, you will make out this symptoms there. And this condition is there. A stroke patient, usually I think you can treat. So we have to do it, and now I'll show. So what is this murcha? It will occur due to rasa, rakta, samjana, sotas gets avarana by tamo dosha. You get madamur sanyasa. This madamur sanyasa is yathotaram baladikyam hetu ingo prashantishu. Madha is mild, murcha is more, and sanyasa is very grave situation. These things you should diagnose. And when this is there, we can treat. So this is the about sthana vishesha analysis. Now coming to hetu vishesha means yatha vata dushti, that we have to see. Yatha vata dushti. Yatha dushti yana dosha yana tha chanavasa. Samprapti means you have to see how dosha prakopa has happens. Where sansamsha you understood now. Yatta tiriya gadamani urdva deheta. Yatha dosha dushti, that we have to understand. Because before giving a treatment, unless you understand this yatha dosha dushti, we can't treat. So one is sthana samshaya understanding, and one is dosha dushti understanding. So this dosha dushti, you see, vata prakopa means, vata prakopa may be by three means. One is dhatu kshayat vata prakopa, and one is margasyavaranena cha, by margavaranat vata prakopa. Cha means dhatu kshaya due to margavaranat. If you understand this one, by ruksha hita virudahara, dhatukshayaka, svata prakopa, gets answered of the disease. So one way. Second means marga avarana. Kapha, pitta, rakta, mamsa, medha, asti, majja, shukra, vid, anna, mutra. So anything can block the movement of vayu in the body, because vayu is a moving entity, all other stable entities. A stable entity can block a moving entity anywhere in the body. So these things can block movement of vayu. Then gets the samshaya, you get a vataya vyadi. Here, the interesting is kapha and pitta vrata vyadi will be sarvadeka, whereas raktavarana vata will be ekadesha, just like pakshagata. Whereas mamsavarana medavarata astyavarata vidavarata will be, these diseases will be in that particular srotas that we have to see. So ekadesha means, in raktavarana means ekadesha, it can happen anywhere in the body. So then comes by this, like this prakruta gets sansamsha, you get different diseases, what Charakar told, I have told. So then comes cha. Cha means initially avarana symptoms are more, but dhatukshya symptoms are very less. As time passes on, dhatukshya avarana symptom comes down, dhatukshya symptoms takes over. How to understand this phenomena is this dhatukshya and avarana, because it's slightly confusing. So you can understand by a simile of a river. If you take a river, in summer, what happens? From Moola Srotas itself, all it becomes dry. Say, water-filled river, when it is dry, it is filled with air. That is Dhatu Kshayat Vata Prakopa. From Moola Srotas itself. That is one type. Another type is, when a river is flowing, you put a dam. Dams, all except Vayu, all others are, you can put a dam. Kapha, Pitta, Rakta, Mamsa, Medha, Asti, Majja, Shukra, anything. When it is blocked, water level increases, that is vata prakopa, moving force increased, vimarga on, you get a disease. So here, initially, avarana, this pathology is more. As time passed on, slowly, what happens below stream, a water area is becomes water filled area, become dries up. That is avarana, that is cha. A patient may come in any stage, avarana stream more, or avaranat dhatukshya stage more. So when the a patient may come to you, in which avastha, this is full avarana avastha, 50% dhatukshya, or 10% 90% dhatukshya. If, for example, a pakshagata patient, if you see, initially when he comes to you, there is only avarana symptoms are there. There is no degeneration in the body. But as time passed on, 3 months or 6 months, all his limbs become wasting there. That is a degeneration. Why it has happened? Because of this avarana, that is cha. So if a patient comes in avarana stage, the treatment should be avarana hara chikitsa. This block should be removed. If patient comes in dhatukshya state, your treatment should be brahmana chikitsa. That is why avasthavashena chikitsam kuriyat. That is why he said this concept. Dhatukshaya, avarana, then cha, dhatukshaya due to avarana. Patient come to you at any stage, we have to diagnose and give treatment properly. So coming to this is when you in a clinic, how you will diagnose? Is it pitta avarana? Pitta avarana will be dhatrishna, shulam, brahmastama. Shula is what symptom? All other pitta symptoms will be there. In kapha avarana, shula is kapha vata symptom. All other shaitya, gaurava, katvadi, upashevadikam, these are all kapha symptoms. These two symptomatology, if you see in charaka, this is sarvadhika symptoms. Then coming to rakta avarana, why I am saying it is ekadeshika. Rakta avarte daha arti kapvam santara jogurisham saraga shayatu jayanti mandalani cha. There will be mandalani spherical swelling will be there. It cannot be sarvadhika. It is ekadesha. Somewhere in the body it should happen. And daha, arti. Arti in Bhaktivan Swami. Instead of that, Sushruta used the word sparshadvesha, that is tenderness or redness. These signs and symptoms will be there. If you see how this raktavarana vata prakopa can happen. So this daha, arti, raga, shvetu, sparshadvesha, these signs and symptoms will be there. It can happen anywhere in the body. So how it can happen? For that, we can understand by a simile of a road. Traffic. You see, in a traffic, heavy vehicles and small vehicles will go. So if you see, vayu and rakta, both are moving in the raktava srotas or rasava srotas. Rasa and raktava srotas, where they are moving. Vayu is a sukshma and chala, rakta is hara and drava. When you compare vayu and rakta, vayu sukshma then rakta. Rakta is sthula then vayu. Just like in a traffic, a rakta srota damage or rakta damage, then rakta blocks the movement of vayu. Just like in a traffic, heavy vehicles are going, lorry, bus, etc. Small vehicles like bike, scooter, etc. are going. If anywhere a road is damaged or rakta is damaged, rakta srota is damaged, or if one bus or lorry is damaged, still you negotiate your bike or a scooter, small vehicle, why you will go. After some time, 3, 4, 5 bus lorry comes. First rakta stops, then rakta itself block the movement of vayu. Bus lorry stops, then that itself stop the movement of bike, scooter, etc. Then accumulation of vehicles. Mandalani shayathu. Heated exchange between drivers. Daha. Redness. Loss of function. Pain. All these things happen. These are 5 signs and symptoms of inflammation according to Western system of medicine. In Ayurveda, we call this condition as Vrunashodha. It can happen. It can happen in the body. So to happen this, just like that, in the context of Pakshagata, stroke, it occurs in Tiryagadhamani, Urdva Dehaga. Due to hemorrhage, due to infection or any cause, it can happen at the Tiryagadhamani, Urdva Dehaga, Anyatara Sandhuvibhata, Moksha occurs. So it happens, to happen this, there should be a Rakta Dushti or Lori Dushti. Rakta Dushti should be there. That is why in Charaka he says for Rakta Dushti, see, first line you see, Pradushta Dikshnoshtyamadhyavatira Tilamanakshari, Pitta Sarupa Rakta Dushti. Why I am saying Rakta cannot block by itself Vayu, because Vayu is a dosha, Rakta is a dhatu. Dhatu cannot block movement of Vayu. So when you see why this occurs, first, Rakta Dushti should happen. By Ahara Viharas, a Pitta Swarup Rakta Dushti, Kapha Swarup Rakta Dushti, or Vata Swarup Rakta Dushti, or Vidosha, or Sannipa Swarup Rakta Dushti occur. Then this Dushita blocks movement of Vayu. Then there will be Mandalani Shvetu. So, first line is Pitta Swarup Rakta Dushti Karana. Second and third is, if you see in this shloka, Kapha Swarup Rakta Dushti Karana. Whereas fourth and fifth, there will be Vata Swarup Rakta Dushti Karana. And another karana is abhigata, injury, road traffic accident, injury. One is ahara vihara, and one is injury. And another one is infections. Rakthadishtana jan prayo vikaran janayanti. That is why we can explain how your tuberculosis or encephalitis can cause a pakshagata, a stroke-like symptoms. One is by injury, and one is infection. Third one is by ahara vihara. Now we are discussing about ahara vihara cause. Infarct, hemorrhage occurs due to ahara vihara. So by this there will be, and it is clear now that rakta swata prakopal ishtu vrnashota, which can occur anywhere in the body. Vakmam sirasnayu sandhi asti marma koshta. And also causes of rakta dushti vikaras according to sthana samshaya, there will be different diseases. This rakta swata prakopal vrnashota becomes a nidanarthakara vyadhi. Vyadhi is a nidana, that itself is a nidana. That that raktaanu vata prakop, this prakopita vata gets sansam shay tiryaga damani urdva dehaga, that is shiro marma, you get a pakshagata. That is why Sushruta used this word as dosha abhigata ja marma, dosha abhiga, dosha abhigata ja raktushtya, dosha ja marma abhigata ja pakshagata, dosha abhigata ja marma ja paksha shiro marma ja pakshagata. This point of use by Sushruta, and one is by abhigata itself occurring, and one is by Krimi can, by in Krimi also, dosha swarupa raktushti should occur, then raktavarna vata brahma will get a pakshagata. Then when you treat such cases, if abhigata shalya chikitsa, if it is dosha dushti, dosha amapachana chikitsa should be given, which dosha like that you have to see. If it is a pitta jahara vihara, smoking, alcohol, then pitta swarupa raktavarna vata brahma, you get pitta symptoms. In a pakshagata, you get a symptom, dana murcha. Or kapha swarupa raktushti, kapha symptom. Staimitya, heaviness, or vata sarupa, keval vata symptom, or vidosha sanipata. Usually acute stroke, they come with the kapha and pitta and vata, all three symptoms will be there. So you have to diagnose and accordingly you have to give. When you so patient presenting with the madham or sannyas along with the pakshagata or akshepaka, then cause of raktushti has visited. If it is due to krimi, you should treat raktaja krimi chikitsa. That is krimi chikitsa, you know, nidana parivarjana apakarshana is panchakarmas, and prakriti vighata chikitsa is killing of the krimi. Before advancement of microscope, this is done by anumana pramana. After advancement of microscope, you can see which krimi is involved. Then many antibiotics are developed according to Western system of medicine. Then they have started like that. If it is abhigata shalya chikitsa, dosha jadushti dosha apachana. When the krimi is treated by antibiotics according to Western system of medicine, according to Ayurveda, Sushruta said many drugs like Surasadigana, Ksharodaka, and Gomutra, etc. Many drugs are told. In vitro, it is useful. In vivo, we have not studied. Usually, whenever a patient comes with the infection, tubercular infection, we refer the case for a antibiotic treatment, prakriti vighata chikitsa, by Western medicine trained doctors, because it is useful to the patient. Now, we are mostly concentrating about doshaja rakta dushti raktaranu vata prakopa causing the pakshagata. So when you treat, the treatment principle told in Sushruta is, when pitta vata involved, first pitta should be treated, then vata. When kapha vata involved, first kapha, then vata. If kapha, pitta, vata, all three doshas involved, first pitta should be treated, then kapha, then vata should be treated. So analyzing the treatment, because pitta involvement indicates murcha. What is murcha chikitsa? Shita lava gaha, shita pradeha, shita rasheka, pitta jvarahara chikitsa, and shiro, tikshna shiro virechana, abhikshna, repeatedly, and vama. Question arises, how you are giving tikshna shiro virechana even mochham piktam pradhanam tikshne nasya vamane nayuktah tatha api even though samjna meeting is not streaming. Okay. Am I audible now? Hello?
Yes, sir.
I think I slight technical problem happened.
So you can continue.
1 minute. I'm sharing the screen. So if it is a doshaja rakdoshi, that has to be treated. So when pitta vata kapha, you know, first pitta shubhri, then vata, when kapha vata, first kapha, then vata, kapha pitta vata, vata, you know, first pitta, then kapha, then vata should be treated. So pitta ja, this one is murcha is the pitta samanya lakshana. So what is murcha chikitsa? Shita seka shita vagaha shita lapaniya pitta jwarahara chikitsa and tikshna nasya. Here question arises, why you are giving tikshna nasya even though it is a pitta pradhana pitta samanya vyavastha, why you are doing it? Same question arises to Dallan also. He says yadyapi sarva murchaya pittam pradhanam tikshne nasya nam uttaha tathapi samjaha sroto nirodha shanti karatva vyadhi pratyekha. See, whenever you do nasi, you give abhyangana sveda. Here, in a pitta pradhana, you are doing sheetala dhara, sheeta, alep, all these things. After sheetala chikisa, you are giving tikshna nasya. Once sheetala chikisa done pittahara, then vyadhi urdhi, you are giving tikshna nasya to remove the tamo avarana. That is why you are doing sroto shodhanakas. So that is prabuddha samjha, you are giving this medicine grata so this kalambu samashakara shata and jwaragna dravya should be given and kalyanaka sarpi matulunga shilajitu chitraka pippali, these are rasayanas are told. It is for murcha chikitsa. Coming to pakshaghat chikitsa, so I have explained a murcha of a symptom, a pitta symptom of a Pakshagata, I have explained. Now, a Pakshagata chikitsa, he said, Tatra praga sneha swayopanna mruduna shodhane samshodh anuasya asthapya cha yatha kalam. Mrudu sneha swedana and mrudu shodhana, mrudu virechana samshodhya asthama should be done. It is for Pakshagata. Then this word comes, cha yatha kalam akshepaka vidane no pachare. What do you mean by that? If a patient has Pakshagata, he comes in state of akshepaka, what you should do? Should you do Pakshagata chikitsa, abhyanga sveda and mrudu virechana or akshepaka chikitsa? Naturally, a patient of pakshagata comes in state of akshepaka. Your treatment should be akshepaka chikitsa. That is why they say, idam eva pradam idam na avadhanam chikitsayam avastha vidhanam. Which avastha? The patient comes in this avastha, you treat akshepaka. What is akshepaka chikitsa? Here you see, tatra prageva sneha abhyaktam siddham apidena tikshnena upakara shirashudhyartam tikshna shiro virechana nasya should be done. Then tana vidari gandhadi pakva sarpi rachancha accha sarpi pana should be done. By that what happens? Nati matra vayu prasarati, vayu prasana to shakas are prevented. Here one question comes, how much sarpi should be done? This question comes. Usually accha sarpi, without mixing anything, you have to give sarpi. Then if you see this snehana dhyaya, a patient of madha, murcha, sarpavisha, udmada, for these patients, he says you should give prabhuta mantra of gritafana. That is why we are giving about 250 to 300 ml of grita directly. Just after nasya, patient awakened, you give that much grita. Then all snehana goes to all shakas. Then after that, the akshepaka is prevented. There is no question of akshepaka at all afterwards. That is why this Sushruta said you have to give sarpipana prabhuta matra. Then parisheka, abhyanga, sveda, this treatment. Then sneha virechana, after nasya sneha virechana, asthapana, anuvasana. Like this, dasharatra huta vega upakramata. 10 nights you treat akshepaka only. After that, you are giving vatavyadhi chikitsa. Prakshaga chikitsa only afterwards. If the patient of prakshagata comes in akshepaka, if you see the acute stroke patient comes to you, they usually have akshepaka, means don't think there is a macro level conversion. There may be slight movement of eyes and rigidity of muscles. If you see their muscles are very rigid, that indicates it is akshepaka. Then your treatment should be akshepaka, not prakshagata. If there is no rigidity, if patient has flexed muscle, he comes, then you go for akshaga chikitsa. But usually, most of the stroke patient, when they come in acute state into ICU, they will have akshepaka state. So then, these are the treatment for eta shuddha vata apatanaka, kevala vata apatanaka chikitsa. Samsrishta, usually the patient who come to us, he may be pakshagata or akshay, they come with pitta samsargaja. Pitta samsargaja means madha, murcha, all these things, semi-conscious state is there. Then what you should treat? Then he says, samsrishte samsrishtam kartavyam. Then jejata samsrishte vatarakta chikitsa. You give vatarakta chikitsa. If you see the vatarakta chikitsa, there are kaphaja, pittaja, vataja vatarakta chikitsa. Since it is a pitta samsargaja, pittaja vatarakta chikitsa, we should take. That is why pitta prabale, raksha dekashaya, pitta jwarahara kashaya, guruchi kashaya, chandanadi kashaya, madhuru pitta sarpi, shatadavata gratalepa. All things what are told for madha murcha sannyasa treatment, same treatment told by pittaja akshepa chikitsa. Shonita avarana means artha shonita ki chikitsa. With this analysis, treatment of pittaja vatrakta, shita parishe, shita alepa, shita madhura kashaya, pitta jwarahara chikitsa. Same treatment hold for pitta samsargaja akshepaka with pakshagata. In addition to this, tikshnas is given according to sthana of the disease. Same line of treatment hold for madha murcha sannyasa. So that is why in Rasavaisheshika Sutra he says, idam eva pradham idam naayit avadhanam chikisayam avastha vidhanam hi pradhanam. Which avastha patient comes to like that, you have to treat. Then he says, any vaidya, he do tarkya with the logical analysis. Without logic, you can't do it. With the logical analysis, avastha desha kala bala, with the, by seeing, kurya uhya swayam dhiya, with your own intelligence, you do uhana. Which dosha is there? Is it dhatukshaya state, avarana state? Or from where he comes, all these things you do with the logical analysis. Then select a specific treatment. Without, vina tarkena, without logic, you give some treatment, if patient. Always you do logical analysis and give the treatment. So with this analysis, I think you understood hetu sthana vishesha. Sthana vishesha tiregam urdhudega. Hetu vishesha pitta svarakta dushti raktavana or kapha svarakta dushti raktavana or pitta kapha svarakta dushti raktavana. Usually acute stroke, they come with this conditions. So to conclude, a semi-conscious unconscious, madha, murcha, sannyasa, akshaya, pakshagata. The treatment is, you have analyzed satudushti by dosha or krimi or abhigata, you analysis, you do analysis, then you have to give the treatment. So with this concepts, now patient comes to you in your clinic, how you treat? A patient comes to me. A sthana vishesha, that means a one-sided weakness or akshaya is there. My diagnosis sthana vishesha, tiryagadam urdhva dehaga. Then what I do, I send confirm it by a CT scanning or MRI scanning. By that you will understand, is it occurred due to infarction or hemorrhage? Dosha or infection by krimi, or is it growth? Is it by injury? These things you can diagnose. Is it by abhigata? Is it by krimi or dosha vaishamya? You understand this one? Then you have to see which dosha involved, hetu vishesha. Madha mursanyas indicates pitta samanvaya, heaviness, numbness, these things indicates vata samanvaya, kapha samanvaya, or ruja and vakstamba and ekadesha indicates, ekadeshaja and sparshadvesha indicates raktavana. Since it's ekadeshaja, you tell it's raktavana. For that, raktadushti baby kapha, pitta, vata, you have to analyze, or tridosha, sannibhata, analyze it, and give the specific treatment. The treatment management line with this analysis, we say, pitta samanvaya state is there, first acute state, shita parisheka, shita alepa, and tikshna nasya to remove the srotorodha, then accha sarpisapana to prevent akshepaka, and shunti swarasa jwarahara chikitsa, amapachana chikitsa, narikala jala, trifala, kamaduda with mukta, mutinjarasa or lakshmi nandrasa, and rasona bhinda. This thing, according to dosha, you should select the drugs. Don't give the same treatment for everyone. Next time, we'll tell what are the drugs. If it is due to krimi pratyugacha, if it is abhigata, shalya chikitsa should be done. How this can be done in a ICU setup, let us see. I will show some videos now. So, here you see a patient of aged 70 years. He is blind from birth. Came to me. He in ICU. I sent him for a CT scanning. We diagnosed this patient is of a lacunar infarct, right-sided weakness. Immediately as he come, we start to apply Shatadhauta Grita Alepa all over body and Dhanyaka Hima, Dhanyaka and Amalaki Himadhara is done. This one person start to apply the Shatadhauta Grita from head to toe. This is very important to Sheetala Chikitsa. So another person start to do the dhara. Even with the giving oxygen and all these things also, we can do this treatment in a ICU if needed. This is in semi-conscious state. So this applying the Shatadhauta Grita Sheetala Chikitsa all over body, even leaving without leaving an inch of the body, you should apply all over body. It's very important. Yeah. We are applying Shatadhauta Grita. Backside, anterior, everywhere it should be applied. Another person does the dhara chikitsa, himadhara, anyakarnamla himadhara from four angula. With the giving oxygen also, if you with the pulse oximeter, all these things, we can do this dhara chikitsa. It is done about 20 to 30 minutes, about 4 to 5 times a day. Even the patient comes in midnight, we do immediately. This treatment is very important. Say Shatadhauta Grita is applied, dhara is done. After about 20 minutes, then dharana should be done with the cleans and manjishta adi churna with the Shatadhauta Grita taladharana is done. Okay. After that, we put the Tikshna Nasya. You see, this patient is able to raise his left hand and left leg, not able to raise the right hand and right leg. So complete right-sided weakness is there. It's in semi-conscious state, Pitta Samanvaya state. That symptom is Pitta Samanvaya symptom. Okay. Then, I put the Tikshna Nasya. About Ashta Bindu means it becomes approximately 1 mL to 1.5 mL. That much Nasya is added, put into the nostrils. Just you see what is his reaction just after applying the Tikshna Nasya. Okay, means without, who can't move his leg, limbs, he start, just after Nasya, he started to raise his right leg also, just you see, immediately. So immediately there is a response, you see, started to raise, just you see what happens. Yeah. Now you see he is able to raise his leg. Who could not raise, he is able to raise the leg. That's just strength. Now we are doing this dhara about 5 times and nasya about 3 to 4 times a day, 3 times a day. So that by 2-3 days he becomes stabilized. He's, if you see the BP, even a patient comes with the 250 by 130, 150, I think this dhara and nasya BP comes down to 160 to 100 without giving any antiagonists, just by this procedure. Now, why it happens like this? How it works? Let us analyze it. Why it happens? Just you see, first of all, why BP raises in a stroke? In a normotensive person, so if you come with the stroke, his BP gushes into 200 by 130 just after stroke. Hypertensive man, it's okay. In non-hypertensive person, so if he comes with the stroke, his BP raises. Why it happens? See, in this area, it is a death happens. By this, there will be a big area of inflammatory swelling. Due to this inflammatory swelling in the brain, it's a big area of congestion. Congestion decreases blood supply. These brain cells cannot live without oxygen for 3 minutes. When there is a decreased blood supply, they start to irritate like anything. It irritates whom? It irritates hypothalamus. We don't get blood, oxygen. So immediately hypothalamus thinks that there is some problem, blood does not come. That stimulates adrenal glands to release adrenaline. So peripheral muscles resistance increases, occurs, constricts, and heart beats more, so that BP raises, gushes up immediately after stroke, so that it thinks that blood will be there to the diseased area, but there is already a block or a hemorrhage. So this vicious cycle, that is always elevated blood pressure, usually in a stroke, if there is no shock. So in such a condition, if you forcibly reduce blood pressure, is not the treatment. So nowadays, your neurologists, they don't reduce the blood pressure so fast. Slowly, slowly, they are stabilizing. Now, how Sushruta managed these conditions? You see, without knowing your blood supply or your brain, all these things, blood pressure, everything, how? Yes, by a mathematical principle of Tridosha Siddhanta of Ayurveda. What he says a Madha Murcha symptom comes that indicates a Pitta Avarana. Pitta is there, Pitta Dushita Rakta is there. That is why he says you do Sheetala Chikitsa all over body. Then you are giving Tishnas, Srotarodha goes. This is according to Ayurveda, according to Western medical medicine's explanation. So can you explain it? Then what happens when you apply this Sheetala Chikitsa on our body? All body activity reduces by Sheetala Chikitsa. When the activity reduces, corresponding nerve activity also reduces. When nerve activity reduces in peripherally, central nerve activity also reduces. When activity of nerve reduces, need of oxygen reduces. Then when need of oxygen reduces, immediately information goes to hypothalamus, there is no irritation to hypothalamus. So there is no irritation to adrenaline to produce more insulin. That will be reduced. That is why as we are going after Shatadavatan Grutta and going on doing Sheetala Dhara Dhara Dhara, slowly, slowly blood pressure comes down. Then without disturbing system, we are putting nasya, blood gushes into brain immediately. Patient raises his hand or leg, and at the same time, according to this level of pathogenesis, then but BP slowly, slowly comes down, his patient is stabilized. The drug usually we used for the nasya is ST Pippali Vacha Maricha Hingusainda Valavana. This again, according to if a patient wants, if it is a Pitta Jamada, usually. Cases of hemorrhagic stroke, they will have pittajamada lakshana. The tikshnata of nasya is reduced by using ST Pippali Kshira. A kaphajamada, infarct stroke, usually they have kaphajamada lakshana. We give ST Vachamana Singh Saindava Kshira or tikshna dravyas nasyas. Or we can give shwasagutara or lashunaswarasa nasya is given according to tikshnata level of the consciousness. So we are giving how much times should we give? Abhikshnam said, Abhikshnam repeatedly means once in 5 minutes or 10 minutes, we can't say. But Sushruta said, per day you can give 3 nasyas. That is why we are giving 1 yama matra, 1 nasya we give. So repeatedly we give the nasya. And dhara and nasya is done. By that patient gets awakened. About 2-3 days we do like this. When the patient is, you see, after getting giving nasya, patient awakened, we give. Achya Sarpipana Prabhuta Matra. then after about 3 to 6 hours he give tarpana chikitsa, shunti swarasa, amapachana shunti swarasa is given, and narikela jala is given. This patient is start to drink. Now you see, this is a scanning report. It is a lacunar infarction. So after about 2-3 days we do, when the pittahara has happened, then we give mrudu virechana, complete pitta shamana occurs. This one also akshepaka avastha also gone. Then we give next stage kafara. Then pitta symptoms are gone, patient will get the kapha symptom like sthaimitya and heaviness. Then we give ruksha alepa. Then acute state treatment is over now. Now patient becomes chronic, stabilized. Then we start to give ruksha alepa chikitsa. Ruksha alepa is applied. It is ruksha alepa. It's a given all over body like this. It should be applied. One day applied, next day again patient takes a bath, again this applied. This is about we do about the kafara chikitsa, and for abhyanga we start to give katu taila sarshava taila for abhyanga, and basti is given. Kapha samandhe give eranda taila with gomutra. If pitta samandhe give eranda taila with godukta. So kapha pitta both is there, eranda taila with godukta and gomutra is mixed and given or mrudu virechana. Then abhyanga nasya done. They applied all over body. Okay, the same patient is just after 15 days he is walking on his legs. This is what happens. The result will get within 15-20 days. He is blind. That is why I have to take him his hand. This is the result you get. Same person you see is walking. Another patient, a stroke of hemorrhage, came on 4th July 2004. See, it's a big hemorrhage. There is no midline shift. So just after 20 days, you see, came on 31st July, all his hemorrhage is gone. See, it's relieved. It's the same person, vertical, not horizontal. Another person's this one, even intracerebral, intraventricular extension is there, bleeding, came on 27th January, we treated. After that, you see, on 19th February, is almost resolved. There is no gliosis, also not happened. The same patient on her legs. This is what result you get. Treatment is same given, but the pittahara chikitsa is more. It's an hemorrhage state or pittaja symptoms are more. So another patient, I will, this is my last case presentation. A patient came with, you see, the physiological activity become pathology corrected by functional activity you have seen. What about anatomical change? Does it change? You see, here is a patient with a big aneurysm, with the hemorrhage, subarachnoid hemorrhage. This patient was posted for surgery, but patient refused surgery and they opted for Ayurveda. They came to my hospital with this condition, semi-conscious state and one-sided weakness. I said weakness. They came to my hospital. I started my same protocol treatment according to ECT, pitta, kapha, everything analyzed according to treatment. After treatment, after all these treatments, just you see his angiogram, so there is no aneurysm now. It's all gone. Anatomical change also corrected. See, now it become normal brain scan. Normal MR angiography, anatomical change also can be corrected. This is same patient after 20 days. She is ready to go outside the hospital vertically, not horizontally. Now almost she's cured after 1 month follow-up. Absolutely all right. Usually we have to treat about 3 to 4 months. Yes, this is the result. So accordingly, stage of murcha, murcha chiksa should be done. Pitta samsargaja akshepaka, shita parisheka, shikshnanasya, tarpipana, shitalapaniya, jvara chikitsa, repeatedly. After then kafahara chikitsa. Then if still disability is there, yes, if vice means there will not be pakshagata at all. I hope you understood. There is no pakshagata at all. Then no need of giving vataja chikitsa, sabhyanga, shashtika, spindaswa, no need at all. But if it is there, then you have to give tailadhara, abhyanga, basti, all this for 3 to 4 months you have to treat. So to conclude, the dosha vikalp after presentation of vyadi in different patients, accordingly, different stage is most important. If a patient comes in the next stage, usually, or a patient of this one, you may need a shamana ushadi. Usually what I do, if a kapha samanvaya, kapha jarakdusti, then I usually select the drugs like rasonapinda, yogaraja kukulu, samirpannagrasa, or mallasindura. These are tikshna dravyas. When the pitta samanvaya, pitta surakdusti rakta anuvata, usually maybe hemorrhage or infarction, but according by signs and symptoms, we should diagnose according to Ayurveda. The drug used is like Kamadudud Mukta and Swarna Sushekara and Draksharishta, Draksharikashaya, this group of drugs we select and or Bala Shatavari Mulakshirakashaya, these things we treat. So accordingly, you get the result. After dosha vikalpa, accordingly, chikisa has to be done to get maximum benefit. In present era, to succeed in Ayurveda treatment, our treatment should be better than best in modern system. Because a contemporary system of medicine is there now, it should be better than best. As per my experience of treating, I think almost 1,000 more patients with acute stroke syndrome. Now, last 18 years I am treating, not just 12 years. I think it is old slide. We can give better result with the Ayurveda with utilizing more advanced diagnostic management equipment and drugs. Some drugs, you see, some limitation is there. Once you put the nasya, if the patient could not drink, then what you have to do? That is a limitation. If there is a midline shift, if in a scanning MCA territory and midline shift is there, usually the such patient or bulbar palsy, they could not drink. Hello, am I audible? Hello?
Yes, sir, you are audible now, but the last 2 minutes it was not very audible.
Audible, huh?
Now it's audible.
How much gone now? How much you didn't hear? This slide you heard completely? Hello?
Only last 1 minute has a problem, otherwise it's okay.
Okay. So I will tell again. So after dosha vikalpa, according to chikitsa, has maximum benefit. This dosha vikalpa is very important. If a patient of acute stroke, he comes with the pitta samanya. Usually a hemorrhagic patient comes with the pitta samanya lakshanas. A infarction stroke usually comes with the kapha samanya lakshana. It may be infarction hemorrhage, but according to Ayurveda, you should find out pitta samanya or kapha samanya according to Ayurveda. Then you have to give treatment. If a kapha samanya, usually I select the drugs for orally is lakshana pida, samira pannagarasa, malla sindura, etc. And dashamudvarishta or yogaraja guddulu. If patient of pitta samanya, usually I select the drugs like swarna sutshekara, kamaduda vidmutta, or drakshadikashaya, draksharishta. And for grita, if pitta samanvaya, I select mahatikta grita. If kapha samanvaya, I select panchagavya grita. If it is kevala, I select kalyana grita or prabhutasneha. So this is very important. So in present era, to succeed in Ayurveda, our treatment should be better than best from modern system. Western system. Contemporary system is there. That is why our thing should be better. Then only patient comes to you. As per my experience of treating any number of cases, we can give better result in Ayurveda with utilizing modern advanced diagnostic management equipment and drugs. So, modern drugs, if there are some limitations. If a patient of stroke comes, if he could not drink after nasya, they should be able to drink. Prabuddha Sabja able to drink. He could not drink. A big area of infarction, big area of hemorrhage or a bulbar path, such patient could not drink. If you forcibly give, there will be aspiration. Then you may need to put the RT tube and give the drug. You may need some help of modern medicines, modern drugs. If a patient gets a complication like aspiration pneumonia, you may need a help of modern system. Because infection happens. When infect krimi is there, you need some modern advanced drugs. Patient may go into shock, then you may need the modern drugs. This is the something. With the help of these things, you can give your continue your Ayurveda treatment. So with the, this, I say there are before and after, many slides are there. So I conclude my presentation with this shloka. Satatadhyanam vadaha pratantravalokanam tadvidyachara sevacha buddhimedha kuroganaha. Satatadhyana should be there. Vadaha discussion related to Tantra Avalokana, and the most important is Tadvidyacharya Seva. Which Vidya you want to learn? You do that Vidya's Acharya Seva. That means work along with him. You should have a practical understanding of theory should be there for you. The theory you learned, you bayarted, but it's a practical understanding you know only if you work with the Acharya. Then you gain proper knowledge and you can serve the society. So with this, thankful to Sri Krishna Kumarji and Dr. Mail and other organizers for giving this opportunity to share my experience of treating acute stroke for the last 18 years. I am very thankful. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the lesson. Can we move on to some questions?
Definitely.
Sir, there is a question on Taladharana.
Yeah.
Can you explain how it acts? Taladharana. Can you explain more about it, the mode of action?
Usually, we take Mahamanjishtha with Tatadavuta Taladharana. That is Sheetala Dhara and Sheetala Alepa. I have already told you, this Sheetala Chikisa reduces Pitta. Then we are giving Tikshna Nasya to make him awaken, Prabodha Samanya. When you give Nasya, this is the same Acharya Dallan also asked, why you are giving Tikshna Nasya? For giving Tikshna Nasya, to remove Sroto Rodha, you have to give Tikshna Nasya. But it is a Pitta Samsargavasta, Prabhuta Pitta is there, Madha Murcha is there. That is why you are giving Sheetala Dhara, Sheetala Alepa. It's a type of Sheetala Alepa. When after doing Sheetala Alepa, Pitta comes down, dosha comes down, then as you value the dosha vyadhi viparita chikitsa. You hope I have answered?
Sir, thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, there is a question. There is a possibility of ischemic penumbra formation if BP is voluntarily reduced to low levels. Is it better to maintain till 170?
No, definitely there is a chance of a patient may go into shock. You may maintain the BP with the modern drugs. If you need, you have to take the help of the modern drugs. That is, I told you may need some help of modern drugs in such conditions, extreme conditions. Otherwise, the patient may die.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
There is a question about kriyakramas done in Pakshaghata.
Pardon?
Kriyakramas.
That means?
That all the different treatments that you do for longer duration.
Kriya. I think I have already told.
Yes,
first,
sir.
As soon as acute stroke comes, I give Sheetala Dhara, Sheetalepa, Tikshnanasya for about 2 to 3 days till Pitta symptoms comes down. Then Achcha Sarpipana and this one. Then Mrudu Virechana. I told you, Eranda Thaila with Gomutra, if it is Kapha Samanvaya. Eranda Thaila with Godugda, it is Pitta Samanvaya. If Eranda Thaila with both Gomutra and Godugda, Kapha Pitta is involved. After Mrudu Virechana, we start Rukshalepa and Abhyangavai Katutaila, that is Sarshapataila, and Nilagiri, that is Tikshna Kafahara, and Basti Chigisa, Brihasaindava Taila for Anuasana, and Dashamulavara Mahamanjishtadi Kashaya for Nirva Basti. If it is the Pitta Samanaya with the Kshira Kashaya, if it is Kapha Samanaya, Kevala Mahamanjishtadi Kashaya Basti, about 10 days we do Kalabasti. When the patient starts to walk and he go home, if still it is there, after that, Vatavachi is that the Kapha symptoms all numbness, everything is gone. Then Kevala Vata symptom is there. We give Abhyanga with the Kshirabala Taila Dhara, and Basti with the Kshirabala. Like that, we should give for about 3 to 4 months. Then after 16 days, if needed, you can give Upanasveda or Shastikeshali Pindasveda. And Basti should be done. And Shamana Vashadi, I think I have already told. Chandra Prabha, Yogaraja Gugulu, Rasona Pinda, or Arogya Vardini. I select according to dosha. Swarna Sutta, if Pitta is there, Kapha is there, Samir Pannagar, Marla Sindhura. Like that, I select drugs and new. Okay. Like that, about 3 to 4 months, Shamana Vashadi should be given afterwards.
Okay, sir. Sir, there is a question. Do you recommend to continue ecoaspirin in ischemic CVA along with Ayurvedic medicines?
No. Whenever patient acute, I don't give ecoaspirin at all.
Okay.
But the thing is, after when they go home, when there is no symptomatology at all the symptoms are gone, patient becomes absolutely all right. I usually recommend them either to take Lashuna daily or take ecoaspirin. Because if you tell Lashuna daily, they don't take it usually. They take it lightly, they stop it, and there will be a recurrence of the stroke. Or they can take ecoaspirin daily if they continue. Either thing, according to patient's need, I will give. That's all.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Raksha Alepa medicines. You talked about.
Alepa medicines. Alepa is Raksha Alepa. You see, it has five dry drugs, five wet drugs. Five dry drugs are Maricha, Lashuna, Sarshapa, Haridra, and Lavanga. These are the five dry drugs. Five wet drugs are Nirgundi, Sairayaka, and Banaprasi, and Shigru. These patras, all Gandhadravyas. These are made into a chutney and applied all over body.
Okay. Sir.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes. Sir, any precaution to be taken for nausea in unconscious patient? Any precautions to be taken when doing nausea for unconscious patients to avoid complications like aspiration?
No, by nausea, there will not be any aspiration. Only thing is there will be accumulation of fluid in the throat that has to be removed by suction machine. Suction machine should be there.
Okay.
If you use suction machine, there is no chance of aspiration at all. Nasya directly will not aspirate. Don't worry about it. When after nasya, there will be increased secretions. Patient may aspirate afterwards to prevent that, that accumulated fluid should be removed by suction machine. By directly putting the nasya on the nose, it will never enter the lungs. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, there is a question. Do you recommend physiotherapy after treatment?
Definitely. Vyayama chikitsa should be done for Vyana Vayu. If still there is a weakness, definitely I will recommend it. After fifth day, we start to physiotherapy if needed.
Sir, there is another question. Which nasya is recommended in hemorrhage?
ST Pippari Kshira or ST Kshira? It has ST Pippari Vacha Maricha Hingu Saindava. Remove all Tishna Dravyas. We use ST Pippali and Kshira. But the thing is, hemorrhage or infarction, I am not making this one. How patient presents you, that's important. If patient is having redness and spit on you and krodha, parushabhasya, these pitta symptoms are there. Even though it may be infarction or hemorrhage, my nasya tikshnada will reduce. Okay.
Okay.
If it is hemorrhage or infarction, patient is alpa and asambandha vachana kapha, then nasya tikshnada will increase. And patient is in sanyasa avastha. It may be hemorrhage or infarction. Now you have to give shasvarasa as tikshnada to make him awake. So, Tishnatha is not dependent on the infarction or hemorrhage. Tishnatha is dependent on which dosha involved. Kapha or pitta, like that. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Sir, there is a question. Is there any point to be taken care of when you are doing sarpipana for patients present with dysphagia?
No, that is what I am saying. If dysphagia is there, if there is a midline shift or bulbar palsy, usually then dysphagia. Patient, after nasya, they could not drink. Then we had to put the RT tube and give the Kritapan. Okay. But such cases, usually, their prognosis is very bad. If patient is able to drink, definitely prognosis is very good. We can treat without any modern medicine at all, help of the modern medicine. Most 90% of patients, 95% of patients never need any this one. They, after Tishna Nasya, they start to drink. But when pathology is more, big area involved, big hemorrhage is there, definitely you may need RT tube feeding. If a patient, when patient comes to, directly to me, I am saying, if a patient goes to Western hospital, they come with RT tube, we can't do anything because by that time, it's all condition is gone. Because by forcible reduction of the blood pressure, all these things, or without this Ayurveda treatment, the chances of damage is more for the brain. That's what happens. Then I think you may need modern medicine, what they have given. Along with that, you have to adjust the condition, and accordingly, you have to give modern Ayurveda medicines. Okay.
Okay. Okay, sir. Sir, there is one question about Madhudaga. How and when to use it?
Madhudaga, you can use. Usually, I give after nasya, after Gridhapana, after about 6 hours or 8 hours, we give Shunti Surasa 40 ml and 40 ml Madhu and 40 ml this one sugar, we mix it and give if a non-diabetic patient. That's what we usually do. But directly Madhudaka, I don't practice like that. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. There is one question about Madha and how to manage Madha due to hypotension.
Hypertension.
Hypotension.
Hypotension.
Yes, sir.
Hypotension is dhatu kshayatvata prakopeshi. You give lemon juice with salt. If rasadhatu kshaya is there, you fill it. That's all. That does not come here at all. Here we are talking about stroke. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, sir. Then there is a question. Should we ask the patient to continue the statins, like same as ecosperin? Or is there any Ayurvedic alternatives like Lashuna?
Pardon?
The statins, no. Yeah.
No. You see, when acute stroke, they come, we don't give at all these such drugs at all.
Okay.
No need of giving statin at all. I don't advise it. If there is a statin, stop it.
Okay, sir. Yeah. Okay, sir. Then there is one question. Is there any Tikshna Nasya which is readily available in the market?
No. It should be prepared fresh, you see. Avapida Nasya means you should prepare yourself. Avapidana. You squeeze it. Okay. How you are giving this ready-made Nasya? It is very easy. You can. You are preparing tea, you know, like that. It can be prepared. That's all.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir. I think the questions are finished. Sir, to quote our student Sunil Kumar in YouTube, the best presentation of acute pakshaghata treatment I have ever seen. Thank you, sir, for the thorough explanation of everything related to stroke classically and what is possible clinically. Thank you for sharing your expertise via video demonstration and by answering questions. We are very fortunate to have you with us for this program. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
So, dear delegates, we will take a break of 10 minutes. The next session is by Dr. Ajayan Sadanandan. It will start at 4 o'clock sharp. Namaskaram, sir.
Namaskaram. Is it audible?
Yes, sir. It's audible.
And can I share the... Hello?
Echo. Sir, there
echo
is
a
slight echo.
Now is it correct? Hello.
Yes, sir. What is it?
It's okay now. Is it a echo is there or okay?
Hello, sir.
Now is it okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Echo is there? No.
No, it's okay, sir. It's quite understandable.
Okay. Can I share the screen?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to see?
Yes, sir.
കുറച്ചുകൂടെ കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടല്ലേ തുടങ്ങുന്നുള്ളൂ അല്ലേ?
അതെ സാർ, ഒരു 10 മിനിറ്റോളം ഉണ്ട്.
ഓക്കെ. ഇപ്പോ എക്കോ വരുന്നുണ്ടോ?
ഇല്ല സാർ, ഇല്ല.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. We move on to the final session. This session is by Dr. Ajayan Sadanandan on effective dravyas for emergency situations.
Can I start?
Yes, sir. Wait a second. Dr. S. Ajayan was born and brought up in a family Marma Shastra, knowledge of human vital points. His grandfather, Brahmasri O. Keshavan Narayan Swami, was the first head of Marma department of BAMS and MD from SDM Ayurveda. Continuing, Dr. Ajayan obtained BAMS and MD degrees from Mangalore University and Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, Karnataka, respectively. In 2012, he secured PhD in Dravyaguna from Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishna Rajasthan Ayurveda University, Jodhpur, Rajasthan. His fields of interest are Agastya Marma Chikitsa, Biodiversity Conservation, Ayurvedic Ethno-Medico-Botanical Survey. Presently, he is working as a professor in Department of Dravyaguna Vijnana, Ashtanga Ayurveda Vidyapidam and Chikitsalayam, Vavanur, Kutanad, Palakkad. He is a member of CCIRS for Documentation of Agastya Marma Shastra. He is a member of CCIRS for Documentation on Local Health Traditions and Ethno-Medical Studies. He is a former board member of Studies of Ayurveda, MGR University. And he is a member of the Ethics Committee of AVP Research Foundation. And above all, he is one of the most resourceful persons in Dravyaguna in the country right now. We welcome you, sir, to the program.
Thank you, dear doctor. So today we are going to discuss the effective drugs for emergency medicine. So with respect to the most respected to the Guruji, Krishna Umarji, respected Dr. Mayur, and other respected dear Vaidyas and all doctors. So today we are going to see some of the important effective drugs that mentioned by our classical acharyas, classical books, along with some of the drugs that will be existing in some traditional books of regional floras, and some of the informations that are available in the local papers. So we can go through this short description about the plants utilized for emergency medicine. So here we are going through these headings. One introduction will be there. Then the background and drug discovery in emergency conditions. Then essential karmas and ganas needed for the emergency management, and some important drugs in emergency care, and a discussion part. So when we look into the introductory part of this emergency drugs and medicine means, most important goal of any health system is to protect the life. If the life is there, then only we can able to do something. So the prana, the ultimate thing that is existing in our body, has to be protected. So this is the aim of an emergency medicine. So through the medicine or through any other methods, we can able to protect this vital prana that is situating in our body. So sometimes the prana will go and hide in some places so that our indriyas will lose its functions and enter into a murcha avastha, and sometimes it will go into a very difficult condition of sannyasa. So to bring back that patients to the life is one of the important part in emergency medicines. So here the skill, appropriate technique, logic, presence of mind, courage, along with effective medicines, plays an important role in these types of management. So these emergency includes from an unconscious stage or a bleeding leg stage, or can attempt someone to going to do a suicide. There also a emergency is needed. So some kind of a situation that responds by words or sounds itself will help to bring back the life. If someone is going to commit a suicide, a sudden response from a person in that particular situation by a particular sound or these things, that also can able to deviate his mind from that suicidal tendency, and he can save his life. That also an emergency thing. So here we can see that it is a coordination of so many things. An emergency is needed in so many places, from different disease aspects, some different life activities, and some accidental life things also. Sometimes there may be a lightning is occurring and the patient is becoming an unconscious by direct falling of that lightning. There also there is some emergencies in that. So in our classics, acharyas are embedded the most necessary management of such type of cases in the form of sadhya, ashu, and in some types of in the form of karmas, vikasi, then vyavai. With that, along with that, acharya is mentioning that by shabdam, trasam, adavam, agni, pidanam, sivanam, aharanam, visravanam, or sometimes with dundupi, making some sounds with certain types of medicaments that applied on the musical instruments and to create like that. So like that, we are utilizing various techniques to find out or to getting a solution from such type of emergencies. So when we look into that aspects, our acharyas are also discussed from jwara chikitsa to vadarakta chikitsa. These emergency situations are embedded in one form or another form. Maybe some acharyas are described in the form of an upadrava vyadis, how we can make a treatment for upadrava vyadis. Like that, numerous descriptions are there. But we have to drag out these informations in a particular level, and then we have to apply it in the patients. Just now, Parvajay sir has shared an important information regarding the practical utility of these things that is mentioned in our science to another level. So it needs a continuous, dedicated way of studying the science and implicating the science into another level and documenting its arts of that. Important thing. Because nowadays the health system is that much developed, then only also there will be so many problems that is arising due to health problems, and most of them are emergencies also. So in such circumstances, we need to cooperate all these things in a specific umbrella and to bring out it in a new form so that all the doctors can get the benefits. So here you can see that the emergency is not an one or two days things. From the day old itself, we can see that the emergency is a needed situations. So we can see in Ramayana, the Dronagiri hill is brought out by Hanuman to bring the medicaments to cure the Lakshmana. So Lakshmana is going to die and he has no response. On that time, Mridasanjeevani is the thing that is helped to bring back him to new life. And the most important four drugs that mentioned here are Mridasanjeevani, Vishalyakarani, Sandhani, Suvarnakarani. So till now, we are not able to know that which is the exact that drug is. So a drug which is called as that can bring the life to human beings, that is the Mridasanjeevani. So it's clearly mentioned that in Dronagiri hills of the Uttarakhand area, this drug is there and it can be able to promote such type of good things in the life. And Vishalyakarani, one should has to remove that thing from our body. Any foreign material is coming and sitting in our body, inside it appears there, and then it has to be removed by a particular type of. And Sandhanakarani, one which can be able to join the things. And Suvarnakarani, which is able to make the proper color or complexion of that particular. So like that, if you look into these aspects, we can see that emergency situations are in the past also, and it is managed well by the peoples. And still, if you look into the local traditions and the local peoples, when you go to the forests of those peoples, are not having an access to the multi-specialty hospitals or the present so-called emergency management, what they are doing. Or in the previous aspects itself, in the history, if you see that the most problematic thing that human is faced is mostly bleeding. A simple bleeding may lead to death. So they used so many techniques to prevent these types of bleeding. They selected different types of plants and put their juices to that particular area so that some instant the bleeding has stopped. This is the first emergency situation that found out by the humans. So like that, if you look into the history, we can get so many references regarding these types of usages of things in various parts. In our classics, acharyas are systematically utilized these principles in different forms and embedded in different chapters in the name of some of the specific karmas and the gunas. So there are so many emergency situations are there, we need a particular type of karma. Example, in the bleeding, we need Sandhaniyam. If a jwaram is aggravated and it led to an emergency, then we need a jwaragnam. Then a murcha, murcha condition, we want to give to relieve that murcha. Like that, in numerous situations we can see. So when we look into that aspects, we can see that Acharya has enlisted certain important karmas for the emergency situations. So taking care of these emergency karmas, if you look into these aspects, so for better understanding, it is made to all together that how we can understand in a better way all these karmas associated to each other. So if you look into the first set, Samyasthapanam, Shirovirejanam, Shirovirejanopakam. So the most important part is our samnya. If someone is not responding, he is losing completely his response from indriyam, indriyartham and jnanam, then we have to bring back that one. That is the most important thing in the first way. So there samyasthapanam, Shirovirejanam, Shirovirejanopaka is essential. The second emergency situation is difficulty in breath. If breath is very dangerous condition, then that also will lead to the problems. So there we need Shwasaharam, Kikka Nigraganam, Kasaharam, Jeevaniyam like conditions. That's. So Shwasahara, Kikka Nigragana, Kasahara, these are the most important thing in Pranavaya Srodhas to regain the pranas in the proper level. Next is the bleeding conditions. So once the bleeding is there, we have to stop. So Shonidasthapanam, Sandhaniyam, Prajasthapanam. Why Prajasthapanam is important means sometimes a habitual abortion or excessive garbhasravas will be taking place, that also a very difficult conditions. So there also we have to look into these blood related rektavasrodhas viharas on that aspect. Another is jwaraharam, daha prashmanam, shida prashmanam, sannibadikam, avasmar. So jwara, it may lead to a severe rises and our body will become too heat. The excessive heat can't be tolerated by our body and we will go for a sannivadika avastha or murcha like thing. So preventing that, we need sometimes a daha prashmana. Because excessive heat is there, we have to reduce that heat. Sometimes our body will become, after that will become very cold. After a jwara high and then it will become very cold. So we have to increase our body heatness. So there we need a Shita Prashmana. So the most of the scenarios, we need both these contrasts. Shita Prashmana, Daha Prashmana means to increase that heat. If it is there, Daha Prashmana we have to need. If body become cool, then we have to increase the heat. That's the thing that just now Sarah has also described in the practical level. So first a Shidam, then a hot Tishnana films like that it's mentioned. So it may lead to a Sannivadi Avastha or may lead to an emergency like epileptic like apasmanas. So if you look into these ganas, we can see that there will be so much of similarities will be there in the Dravyas also. So this is also one of the essential karma for emergencies. Fifth is the Shula Prasmanam, Vedana Sthavanam, Angavarda Prasmanam, Sukha Prasavaha. So Shula Prasmanam is one of the important thing that's fortunately related to the abdomen. Then Vedana Sthavanam, in other part of the body, Angavarda Prasmanam, all part of the body there will be any Angas has having severe pain, then Sukha Prasavaha. The most painful situation in a woman's life is this one, the pain of to giving birth to a child. There also we have some emergency techniques. Then another is the Chardi Nigrahanam. If excessive vomiting is there, that also a difficult situation we have to take care because of the excess fluid loss and so many exertion to the Marma Sthanas. Then Purusha Sangrahaniyam. So excessive going out of the Purusham, Malam will be excessively going out, then the person will lose his Bala. So there also we need. Then Mutra Virajaniyam. So there will be an Mutrala Dravyas are needed. Then Ashmari. Ashmari is also a very painful condition and emergency is needed. There also we have to look. And another important area is the Vishaknam, Kanduknam and Udartha Prasmanam. So overall, if you are looking, these are the important karmas. The important karmas, very essential for the emergency management. So these karmas, if you we have a very good idea where it has to be utilized and which medicines has to be utilized, then it will helps a lot in making our emergency medicine practice in a very good level. So next we can go for some of the drugs and the descriptions of these ganas. So if you see the Samyasthavanam, Shiro Virajanam, Jeevaniya, Virajanopaka, these ganas, Ajare is telling that Samya Jnanam Sthavayadi Samyasthavanam. So one which will help you to bring back the Samya. That is one of the important thing. If it is not there, then there may be entering into a tamopravesham and the sannyasam, and the patient will not respond to anything and will die. So we have to provoke that prana in any instant to bring back by giving certain dravyas in the form of churnam or tailas or maybe some lebas or applying to the tongue or something like that. So Ajare is telling that we have to utilize in the form of anjana, Navapidana Nasyam, Dhuma, Pradhamana Nasyam or Sujivisthodanam. So maybe we can utilize some medicated thing by burning and it will be pressing on some places also. Then Daha, Pidana on the Nakhandara, on the below of the nail bit. Like that, we can do various types of techniques to bring back the Samja. And one interesting thing is Atma Gupta Avakarsha. So sprinkling of the hairs of Mikunamo species. So Atma Gupta's hairs, pod hairs has to be sprinkling on a particular part to provoke that particular area and it will lead to an irritation so that it may bring back the patient to life. So like that these descriptions are there. So when we hear that Atma Gupta Karshanam means Kabigachu, Romas of the Pala is putting on the particular part, is it will produce anything? But one research has came from the European countries that by using the leaves of Articaria species, they will rub it on their bodies, those who are having a loss of sensation, and they studied. And they studied, found that by rubbing in a paralysis the person's skin with such type of irritant leaves will producing a specific antihistaminic action and that will stimulating the nerves and it will be helping to provoke the brain cells. So thousands of years back itself, our acharyas are mentioned these things in another level in these small slokas. And another thing what Acharya is mentioning is Madhulunga Rasam Mahaushadha Samayukta along with Savarjala. So here Amlaravyam, Kadudravyam, Lavanadravyam. So if you see the Murcha, Sannyasa managements, the utilization of Kadu, Amla, Lavanadravyas are more. Because to provoke that prana, to bring back that prana, we need Ushna, Tishna qualities, Dravyas, which can fastly spread to these particular parts and to get a specific type of provoking on that particular area. So like that, if you look into these aspects, another important thing is mentioned is Hingu. Hingu Ushna Samyuktam. So that much of penetrating power drugs, we can call it as a Pramadi Karma. Nija Viryena Idravyam Srodokyo Dosha Sanjayam Nirasadi. With its virya, it can able to go back to the extreme level of the srodasas and bring back the dosha sanjayam of that particular level and can provoke these things to bring back the pranas in the normal. So like that, samya prabodhagam with these types of kadu, amla, lavanam is one of the important base thing in the emergency management of Ayurveda. Still it is relevant. So certain patients, those who are completely on a brain death like form in the ICUs, nowadays the doctors are starting another line of treatment. First they will use some pungent taste material to apply on the tongues. They are using the pepper and mirch like things. Then afterwards they are using some amla dravyas, sour taste dravyas, continuously for 3-4 days. Like that a protocol is developing. So we can also have such a depthful things in our samhitas, and one of the important thing is samnya sthapana. And here we have to look into another aspects also. When Jivaniya Gana is mentioning, the Chakrapani Acharya is telling that murchidascha samnya janagattvam evena jivaniya akhyam jivaniyatvam. So Jivana Gana can also be used for these purposes, to bring back the samnya, to bring back the life in its normal form. Like that, overall, if you are looking, the Ganas like samnya sthapanam, shiro virejaniyam, jivaniyam, shiro virejanovagam, all are working. So if you see that, Jyotishmati, Abhamargam, Vaja, Hingu, Ajaganda, Glioma viscosa, Ajaganda, one of the important drug we have to look, then Drona Pushpi, Surasa, Tulasi, Marija, Pippali, Shigru, Vidanga, Sarshaba, Jivaga. Like that, some of the important dravyas only I listed here. These dravyas we have to specifically look on provoking these things. So I think all of them know about these things that is mentioned in our samhitas. Going, not going to the details of this, not going to this detail. But if you see this, the combination of these dravyas are utilized in most of the samnya prabodhagam, shiro virejanam like conditions. So most of the drugs are repeating in samnya sthapanam, shiro virejanam and virejanopaka also. Like that, if you look in, there will be one of the important drug is pratyek pushpi shiro virejana. In Agravshadam also it is mentioned. In Charaka Samhita, second chapter itself is starting with Abhamarga Danduliyam. So that shows that Abhamarga is such an important drug to bring back these types of things. So the tandulam has to be used for these purposes. We can get plenty of references of this abhamarga. Then another important drug is Jyotishmati. So Jyotishmati, Vagni Buddhi Pratiprada. So one which can able to bring back our Agni level, Sushma Agni level, and it can impart the Buddhi and smriti of our thing. That is the Jyotishmati. That much Tishnatvam is there and it has to be used in the proper way, and then it is one of the best samnya prabodhak. Sorry. So like that, if you are looking, we can see that plenty of detailed descriptions of these types of drugs, especially this Abhamarga and Jyotishmati. Another is the Hingu, a Jangaladesha Utpanna Dravyam, which is having such a penetrating and power that can produce Chedaniyam, Deepaniyam, Anlomaniyam properties. So from the koshtam to the vyana vayus, and it can reach to the main marmas like hridayam and shiras. So that is vata kapha prasvanana. So in the most of the time, the sankhas of our body is taking place because of the predominance of kapha. So on that conditions, chaitanyam is necessary. Kapha along with other combinations also. So shleshma combinations with the sometimes amedam or rectam also, sometimes we need a cutting action of that. That chaitanyam, deepaniyam and anlovana property. So vada has to be kept in its normal level. One of the wonderful drug is this kingu. So if you see the yogas, you can see that in nasyam, in the gudigas or churnas, everywhere we are applying this, even in taila form also. So that much of diversity is there in these drugs that can reach to that particular level, and it is very useful in the, if you look into our classical utilization by our acharyas in different yogas. Another is the jivagam. Of course we know that. So that ashtavargam group itself is very much necessary to protect our life. So that can also be used in certain instant to protect our life in its good form. Another is the most important thing in our body is shwasa. If our prana shwasa, the breath is somewhat irregular or it's very difficult to take, then it will be an emergency situation. So there the shwasahara is the one of the important thing. Then hikka. Hikka is one of the symptom of so many emergency conditions, especially in certain cardiac conditions and in certain disease related to the abdomen also, it will lead to hiccups. In these conditions, we need an emergency medicine. Even an urinary incontinence and the retention of urine in the bladder itself will produce a hiccup. In these conditions, we need a specific hikka nigraha dravyas and the same kasaharam also. So we can see that shadi pushkaramulam dhanuyasam karkadaka shrugi agaru tulasi chandanam yashti idrubhala, like that. So yashti, karkadaka shrugi, dhanuyasam, these are one of the important drugs we have to look along with pushkaramulam. So karkadaka shrugi agaru yashti, in the present scenario we have to look into these drugs, I think, because nowadays we are going, the whole globe is going through an epidemic and this will be very severe. And we need some emergency medicines also, especially related to these respiratory things. So it is worth to look into these drugs, karkadaka shrungi, agaru and ST like drugs. So we can see that this pushkaramula. So in agravushadam itself, it's highlighted hikka shwasa kasa parsha shula harana, a drug which can able to produce an ideal movement of our shwasa, especially acting on hridayam and pupusa. So this is the one of the drug we have to look into the ideal constituents, and we have to develop some of the potent arkam like preparations or yogas for these purposes, then it will be very beneficial. So this dravya has having a specific affinity to these organs and can promote a very nice action of regulating our breath. So parshashulam is one of the important and cardinal feature of cardiac related pains, and along with that breathlessness. So in these such conditions, this is one of the very good drug that we can select. Then another is the rasna. So rasna is also, sorry, agaru. Agaru is also one of the important drug we have to look. Because nowadays you can see that some of the infections will producing is such a complicated condition in our lungs tissues. So here, if you see that here, that on this bar, how agaru is getting this medicament? When a mycelium fungus will affecting the 6 to 8 year old hardwood of this Acaloria acalocha plant tree, then the plant will secrete an oil to fight against this fungus, and that oil is the agaru. On that time, the hardwood will become loha varnam, blackish in color, because of the specific oleo gum resin that is secreting by the tree to fight against this fungus. So here we can see that the fighting against such a thing is becoming a medicament. Then the agaru will becoming a very nice thing for our things. So whenever there will be a sheetam, a coolness is occurring in our body, then there may be a chances of more multiplication of all the microorganisms. Whichever the microorganisms is taking inside the body will become too cold, there may be a chances of increasing these things. Here comes the importance of Ushna Dravyam, which can hamper the environment of a Shidatva and to bring back a Ushnatva, so that the Kapharatva will take place and the Krimis will not develop or other Pudha things will not develop. That's why it is useful in Dhubana, useful in Leva, useful in internal medications. Agaru Shida Abhanayana Pralevarana. So it is one of the best drug which can be utilized to bring back the heatness to our body. So this is one of the important drug we have to look. Another important area in the emergency is the Shonida Sthavara. Bleeding is an emergency condition, maybe an internal, maybe an external. We need an emergency because the jiva is residing in the blood. So there we need a Shonida Sthavana and same time a Sandhaniya like drugs. So Shonidasya Dushtasya Dushtam Abhahritya. So if the blood will become impure also, we have to bring back to a normal level. Prakrito Shonidam Sthapayati. If it is going outside or its Prakriti has to be brought back into there, that is the Shonida Sthavana. So like that also, if you looking, you can see that various ranges, in various rodasas the plants is acting. Eshti Madhu, Shalmali, Amrita, Krishnavarni are the drugs are mentioned. In all these ganas, these we can see. So Eshti Madhu will do a Shonida Sthavanam in a particular srodasas. It's related to the Koshtas, Abhyantara Roga Margas. Shalmali will produce an excellent Shonida Sthavanam in Pakvashaya and Purushava srodasas. Amrita can promote a Shonida Sthavanam ideal in bleeding disorders that is occurring on the Bahya Roga Margas and to some extent to the Madhyama Roga Margas. Krishnavarni can promote an ideal thing in the Madhyama Roga Margas. Like that, 10 drugs if Acharya is mentioned, it will having a 10 area of action and its affinity towards that particular areas. So accordingly, we have to select like that. And another important area is the Prajasthavana. So keeping a growth of a child is one of the important things. So if a Garbhasrava is suffering and Rektasrava will result, Prajasthavana has to be done. There also Acharya is mentioning Brahmi, Shadavari, Lakshmana like drugs. So like that, there will be a plenty of drugs are mentioned to promote a specific type of action in particular conditions. So here we can see that the Shonida Sthavanam is a thing which can relate to internal bleeding also. Wherever there is internal bleeding also occur, there also we can utilize these types of drugs for various types of preventing these things. So Eshti Madhu is the one of the important drug that can preventing that internal such types of bleedings. That's why if you see Kandya Varnya Virajaniya Robaniyana, it is one of the best drug that can promote a Robanatvam internally and externally also. A Jangaladesha Utpanna, again, a Jangaladesha Utpanna Dravyam, which is growing on a little bit of watery area, where its root will store all these things, and that will be a very excellent for managing so many conditions. Here we have to look in, using of these drugs in a very minimum dose is also one of the important things we have to keep in mind when we are using such potent dravyas. And Amrita Sangrahika, Shleshma Shonida Vibandha Prashmanam. So here again, Shleshma Shonidam, internal bleedings wherever there will be, and it will producing a Vibandha Prashmanam, a blockages. So such types of conditions where it's going to an emergency, before emergency itself, Acharya can able to prevent these conditions. Acharyas are specifically mentioned certain kashayas and yogas. So in that vyadhyavastha, if we are not giving that drugs or the patient is not taking that medicine, then it will lead to an upadrava or asadhya stages. So these types of drugs will be having that much important in such type of micro circulations, especially related to rasavaha raktavaha sodasas and another utpala kumuda kinjila sangrahika rakta pitta prashmanana. Here the rakta sangrahitvam and rakta pitta prashmanam from an anupadesha utpanna shida dravyas, a drug which is growing on the water area which is having a naturally a shidatvam, will helps to arrest the internal bleedings. So the combinations of the parts of these drugs with other drugs will helps in these types of bleedings. So if you see the garbhavastha bleedings also, the utilization of these drugs will come. And another important drug is laksha satya shada gnana, the best drug that is mentioned in even in Vedas. If you look into Rigveda, we can see that these types of mentioning is there. Laksha is praised too much for sadhaniya actions. So in Kerala Vaidyas, whenever there will be an internal bleeding which is related to yakrat, pleha, to the udaras, or something which is occurring more prone to the pupusa, so these are the some of the structures which are having small small vacant areas. Akasha utpanna, pena utpanna organs. So akasha predominant these types of rows, chambers and connections, such types of things, if any bleeding is occurring, these drugs has to be used. So here if you see the laksha, you can see that small small pores also there. So like that, the combination of laksha and this, laksha and this Padma is one of the good thing that can prevent the internal bleeding capacity, especially related to lungs, liver and spleen. If you see this, there are yogas are also mentioned by our acharyas regarding these conditions. So like that, another important area we will come is jaratna. Fever is one of the emergency situation if it is aggravated, especially in the children's also. So there, along with that, daha prashmanam, shida prashmanam. So sannivada jwaram, if it is entering into a cold stage, then there also we need a thing. And if it is entering into a sannivadika avastha jwaram, there it will be promoting, and maybe the jwara will lead to an abhasmana. So here, if you look into these conditions also, we have drugs which is having a combination of shidam and ushma. Sariva, manjishta, agaru, again coming there, see, shringavera, again ushna, vaja. One of the important thing we have to look is vaja. Simply by keeping and simply by applying itself can promote certain actions. Then draksha, chandanam, kashmirya phala, yashti, kribera, tripala. So a jwaraharam, daha prashmanam, shita prashmanam, we can select from these things. Along with the sannivadi arastha, also we have to look into these aspects and the soul and ideal yogas we have to select. Here, one of the drug we have to present the scenario we have to look is, of course, Ashtimadhu is there. Nowadays, you can see that this problems is associated with respiratory related disorders more broad. So here, the COVID-like conditions like infections, Kribera is another one of the important drug we have to look. Why means acharyas are mentioning that udichya nirvapana deepaniya pajaniya charti adisara harana. Nirvapana, a cooling action that can provide by our body, this drug, along with the deepana pajana. So such dravyas are very less in our classics or in our present practicing. Nirvapanam along with deepana bhajanatvam, a shidatvam with deepana bhajanatvam. Of course, there will be musta is also there, but this drug has having charti adhisara harana. So how much important is this drug for koshta? Acting on amashayam, ama pakvashayam. So, and in pakvashayam also. So in the abhyantara roga marga, this drug has having a very vital role. So please look into the coleus species. We are using coleus species, coleus vetiveroids, coleus silanicus, or such type of plants which is having such type of properties, means tulasi like drugs also is one of the important thing we have to look in the present scenarios especially. these types of things can help to bring down the hotness that aggravated by something. Maybe some storms, like cytokine storms, like things will be produced and excessive immune response will be there. Why this excessive immune response may produce is one of the causes, excessive heat of our body. This excessive heat of our body again will produce an excessive things in our body, means more secretions. So we have to arrest such type of secretions by proper utilization of these types of drugs. That's why in Shataka Paniyam, this is one of the important ingredients. Kri Bera Udichya will be one of the important in Shataka Paniyam because of this property. Of course, Pusta is also having such type of properties. But along with this, if you see the Shida Deepaniya Pajaniya is one of the important thing what we have to look. Another is the Kashmiri Phala. Rekta Sangrahika Rekta Pitta Prashmanam. So here also you can see how much important is there. Something which is related to our Abhyantara Roga Marga and Yakrit Pliha related, there will be a bleeding is occurring. Maybe in a Kamala or in the advanced stage of a Pandu or Rekta Pitta. One of the drug we have to live on is Kashmiri Phala. Because it is having a Madhura Rasa, Guru Guna, and Madhura Vipaka and Shida Drivya. So that is the speciality of this Kashmiri. And it can impart an ideal things in our manas also to reduce the rajas that can increase by the pitta. That can also be reduced by this. So that's why these will come in, if you look into the Drakshadi like Kashayam, this is one of the main ingredient. And if you look into the Susrutacharya's Rasayana Chikitsa also, you can see that these drugs are utilized there. So such types of drugs on the proper time, in the proper combinations, utilizing is also one of the important yukti and karma siddhi of a vaidya in the management of these emergencies. Another is the most important thing is the painful situation that occurring in our abdomen. So in the koshtam, whatever the pain is occurring in the abdominal region, Udara Pradesham, then it will go Shula, simple Shula. That is the Shula Prasthana. So then another is the Vedanas, different pains will be there. And Angamarda Prasthana also. So wherever there will be pain is there, simply relieving the pain is not the Shula Prasthana or Vedana Sthapana of Ayurveda. So here Acharya is specifically mentioning Shariram Prakrityo Sthapayati Vedana Sthapana. So it will bring back the body what it is producing a symptom. So if a symptom along with the pain is there, what is the cause of that pain? That is also balanced by that particular drivya. That is the diversity of such type of utilization of drivyas. So when it is in the koshtam, we will use shulam in the koshtam, panjagolam, jeeragam, gandiram, like drivyas we can use. If it is more than koshtam, to a madhyama roga margam, shala, kadamba, yelavaluga, parnidhoyam, like drivyas we will use. If it is related to a sugha prasava avastha, so some pain, it will be an intense pain during the pregnancy and the pregnancy is not possible easily, we need a proper drug which can you do that karma, that is the langali. Langali like potent drugs will be utilized. So here you can see that a poisonous drivya can also be used in such type of situations where there will be a such scenario. And another thing is the, here we can see that sthira doyam, why it is called as sthira doyam? The sthiram means it can promote a sthirattam to our body. So if you look in the hridroga chikilsa, especially in the vataja hridrogam and tridoshaja hridrogam, you can see that the utilization of parni doyam extensively. And shirabhaga of parni is mentioned for that. So here the prishna parni and shala parni are the, both the drugs which can be able to protect the hridayam. So it is considered to be one of the angavarda prashmanam also. It is considered to be one of the good vedana sthapanam also. Sangrahika vadahara divaniya vrishyana. So in agravishadam also, this is considered to be the best sangrahi. If something is excessively flowing, means if the heart will start to pump very fast, so we need a sangrahanatam there also, because it should be pumped in a specific rhythm and manner. Excessive also problematic, less also problematic. So here in these instances, we need a protective things like sangrahitam of this. Sometimes there may be an excessive nasal discharge, maybe a weeping out of our cerebrospinal fluid from the nostrils. There also we need a sangrahitam. So there also, if you see that in the shavadu and penis chikitsas also, we can see the sangrahi property of this prashnavarni and shalavarni is utilized. Even balance. So there we have to look into these aspects that mentioned by acharyas for protecting these. Here another important thing is the sangrahi action in the garbhasthavan. So in the garbhasthavanam, in the second trimester, if there will be a susceptibility of garbhasravam, abortion, there the sangrahi dravyam for kshirabhagam is mentioned is this one. If the child is not having proper heartbeat when the second trimester, if the scanning is done and the doctor is telling sometimes there will be a heartbeat will be less in a child in the womb in the third month or fourth month, there also we can suggest the kshirabhagam of prashnavarni shalavarni to increase that conditions. So like that, the proper combination of these drugs will be useful in various emergency conditions. Here vidarigandham vrishyam sarvadoshaharam. So one is deepaniya vrishya sangrahi vadakara, another sarvadoshaharam. So these both joining together can become a best sthira guna promoting drug in our body. Sthiratvam is essential in the level of every dharus, even in the vajas. So these two drugs are praised very lot. If you look into the prashnavarni's praising in the Vedas also, it is very much praised through various hymens. And another important and vedana sthapana dravyam that we can use is again a poisonous drug that is ideally used as a medicine. So that much of heatness. So if you see this plant itself, you can see that how much tejo tattva is predominant in this. On the surface of the seeds like this, these things are there, hairs are there. All these shows that these styles will showing redness. So this much of tejo tattva predominant dravyas can promote a very good vedana sthapana. If you look dhatura, there also you can see this. If you look ganja, there also you can see the minute so. So like that, if eranda tailam is one of the thing which abhyaso vartma gulma anila shula harana, it can reduce the shulas. So maybe a madhyama roga margam where sandhi asthi madhya will be involved, there also the best drug for reducing the pain is this one. Whenever there will be a koshta pain, there also one of the important drug is this one. So in gulma and anila haram, so in madhyama roga margam and in abhyantara roga margam, this is one of the best drug that we can accept. Recently I found one of the writing document and case profile of a doctor from European country. So he is an allopathic doctor and he is practicing back pain cases. And how he is managing back pain, and he is written these success stories of his back pain patients, means he is using one technique of applying castor oil in the back of the lumbar region. So simply taking some gauze piece and pouring the castor oil and keeping on the lumbar region is the treatment for backache. So that doctor has found out that it is very good result. And this is the main treatment he has promoting for back pain in an emergency conditions. So see, we have a multidimensional utility of such type of drugs in various forms, in the form of nirgundi adi random like things in an acute emergency conditions where patient unable to sit or stand or lie down. We can use these types of things externally and internally very beautifully, and we can manage it. So such type of things are there in our classics in the form of various yogas. Chardi Nigrahana, one of the important thing, various etiological factors are there. Then also stopping that vomiting is one of the important thing because of such of an exertion, and it will affect the other organs also. So Acharya has mentioned Jambu Pallavam, Amra Pallavam, Yashti, Ushiram, Mrit, Laja. Mrit is one of the Parthiva Dravyam that is mentioned here. So here that this thing also we have to look. Of course, Yashti Madhu already we are discussed. Ushiram is also there. Then the Pallavas, tender leaves. So Jambu, Amram, these things can prevent these types of chardis with has having some unetiological reasons. Ushiram, daha, tok, dosha, sveda, apanayana, pralevana. Here also you can see that Ushiram can bring back the coolness to our body, which is excessively become very heat. So here, these types of drugs also we have to utilize it for preventing the chardis. Of course, there will be so many preparations with these things. So all of them are aware about that. Then another thing is excessive evacuations of bowel or something like adhisara, grahani-like things will be there. Then sariva amrasti, so the cotyledons of mango seed, shonaha, mojarasa, ledjaru, patmakesara. Again, you see, we also discussed this in the shonida sthavana. Mojarasa, patmakesara, ledjaru. These are also coming here also. When there will be adhisara will be excessively, then it will be mixed with rectum. We need a certain types of drugs which is having specific affinity to that particular area and can prevent that with sangrahitum action. So that the excessive flow has to be prevented. So on these instant, we have, it's better to look into these types of drugs also. Then Ananda Sangrahika Raktavita Prashmanana. So no need of explaining this very detailed because everyone can know that. Role of Sariva. The role of Sariva in our Ama Pakvashayam area in the Purusha Sangrihaniyato. So whenever there will be a Shula, a patient is telling that specific shulas that is arising on the morning 3 to 4, 5 blocks. And along with that, they have a gulmatum and excessive pains. There may be a susceptibility of pitta vada aggravations on that conditions. And most of the time, when we do all the investigations, the patient will not having any problems. But the patient has having severe acute pains on these episodes, on these morning hours, and they will wake up with this pain and discomfort. So in such conditions, if you look to the inspection of the patients, you can see that there will be a severe ushnatum will be there on that patients. In such conditions, utilization of yogas which contains the predominant dravya as sariva will play very nice. So rakta pitta prashmanam along with the sangrahi. Sometimes in a visarpam or kushtam, there will be an excessive bleeding with the heat on the body. There also, we need a simple avagaha svedam or dhara, sorry, avagaha svedam, of dhara of this kashaya and pouring on these things can prevent the excessive burning and the flow of blood. Sometimes there will be a severe itching. Along with that, there will be heatness and blood will oozing out. So there, if you put these drugs into the water and simply boil it and just do a kashaya dharam, that can also can help to prevent these types of situations. So whenever there will be an allergic things are occurring and the body is going to an anaphylactic like conditions where there will be more itching, udardam bodam like conditions, we have to look into such type of shita prashmana dravyas. Udardha prashmana dravyas like this. Panchakshiri also one of the nice choice that we can promote. Simply making a kashayam and keeping it like there. And whenever there will be severe itching is occurring, that can take a gauze piece or a kerchief like that, simply dip it in that and rub it. It can give an action similar to as that of a steroid also. But it has to be repeated. within 45 minutes, we have to repeat the, such type of rubbings. Along with that, if you give the proper medications, we can manage such type of conditions also. Another important is that if urine is not gone, so if the high urine retention will be there, then that also will be a difficult condition, especially in the Ashmari. That's why Ajarya Sar Counselor, Ashmari is a Mahavyadi and a very difficult Vyadi. So there we have to look into some drugs which can promote an ideal movement of these things. Adraga is mentioned, Bandaga is mentioned, Gokshira, Vakshana Veda, Prana Panchamula also there. Here also, looking into the conditions, we have to choose and we can utilize this. Certain drugs are there, so which can promote an immediate evacuation of stones in various sizes. So you know that so many people are using so many different drugs and can getting the result. So an emergency condition can be managed by a simple drugs that is utilized by the local traditions. So within one dose, some of the stones are getting out. So usually it is also one of the emergency conditions, there we have to go for a surgery. So like that, utilization of proper drugs by selecting it in the proper time will get yield a very nice result. Gokshiram, I am not going to that. Mutrakrishamilaharama, we know that. Then another set is Vishaknam, Kandugnam and Udartha Prashna. Here also, these drugs will play a very important role in these conditions. So Haridra, Manjushta, Shirisha, Chandana like drugs will be there. So these things. And there is some important drugs in emergency care. We have to look other than the prevalent drug that is mentioned in our classics. Some of the drugs that afterwards has developed, means after the Samhita period, we have developed so many other drugs which will be very effective in these management. So we can see some of the things in a glimpse. Samnya Stavanam, Shiro Virajanam, Virajana Upagam. So there you can see a Clematis Silanica, a drug is there which is used for provoking our shwasas into the normal level to opening our nostrils. So you can see that the utilization of this by this person, by just rubbing it in the root of that and covering it in a cotton piece, and then it will be inhaled. So that the severe Ardhava Bhedaka that will be occurring on the right side means the usage of the left side will, so the usage of the left side will help to open up the right side. If it is on the next side, this is will be inhaled. Like that, Dravyas are there. So for Samnya Prabodhanam and Vedana Sthapanam like this, Ranunculaceae family is one of the important family we have to look. We have to still do so many researches in these plants, then we can surely will get a very good Samnya Sthapanam along with a very nice Vedana Sthapanam Dravya. Another is the important is the Gorojanam, a thing which can pass the blood-brain barrier and can act. So in a Vada Vyadi, a patient is under unconscious and no response is there. Without anything, if you use this Gorojanadi like Gudikam, which is be treated with betel leaves, sorasam, then we can bring back some of the response even in the our eyes. Sometimes eye movement also not there. The patient is completely in a brain death. We can use one of the drug is this Gorojana, because that's much important is there in Gorojanadi Gudiga. So one of the animal products, Jangamadravya, we have to look is this one. Another is the important thing in the shwasas. Gandha Marjara Virya, civic cat. The seminal excretions of the civic cat is the one of the important Atyega medicine in South Indian practice. The physicians always have a small vessel or small bottle which is embedded in this medicine with a small cloth piece. So someone is having a severe breathlessness, this is just smelling. So in Kerala traditional practices, especially in Tamil Nadu and Kerala, if you see, the Vaidyas are extensively used this drug for various forms. Even our Dhanvantaram Gulika actually contains this one. So properly adding this and utilizing this will help to cure these conditions. So Jangamadravyas are one of the important area we have to look to bring back our emergency situations. Unfortunately, what will happen means nowadays it's restricted that this animal has, we can't able to grow this animal or we can't able to collect this. Because of that, such a lineage of practicing these types of ingredients is going to lose. So this is one of the important drug that can provoke our shwasam, our rhythm of heart and lungs. Another is the kasturi. Again comes the same thing, which can promote such an astonishing action to our body. So kasturi, gorojanam, gandhamarjara, viryam. If we have, we can manage so many cases that are related to respiratory disorders and brain related disorders. So we have to bring back the art of practicing, of utilizing this kasturi adi guliga, mrigha, matha, rasa, gandhamarjara, virya, rasas, all these, then surely we can manage these emergency conditions. Another important drug we have to look is glycosmos pendaphyla. The glycosmos pendaphyla in Malayalam it is called as pana. A kashayam that is mentioned in Shwasa Adhikaram is panal veradi kashayam. So this is used by great Rajagopalan sir for cardiac problems. So whenever there will be a cardiac insufficiency is there, Shwasa is the main symptoms and sir is using this one. And it shows that it is having a very nice actions. So these types of drugs are not that much prevalent in the common practice. We have to bring back, then so many emergency situations we can manage with such type of drugs. Another is the Shonida Sthapanam Sandhaniyam. So this is the one of the drug that is especially used in Marma Chikilsas. So in most of the head, Marma Vikhadas. And then what the symptoms means, there may be an excretion of blood through eyes, nose and ears or through the mouth. So simply taking the terminal leaves of this and giving nasyam and keeping it in the murdha and blowing this to the ears, we can able to prevent these types of bleedings. So pandira is one of the excellent drug that can prevent the bleeding. Even in the menstrual bleeding also, if the excessive bleeding is also, again this drug will come. If you have an abscess where there will be an excessive bleeding, again this drug will come. So surely it's very worth it to look into this drug, which is having such a Shonida Sthapana activity in various levels, in the Uttamangam or in the Adharangam. So this is one of the important drug we have to look and come to a practices so that we can manage such type of conditions. Another is this one. In Tamil, it is called as Arthila Poruthi. If you cut these two leaves into two parts and you join it, and if you keep like this, this leaf will join. This is the real Muruguti or the things which can help to bind the things. So if something, a retinal bleeding will be there or something internal bleedings will be there, this is the drug where Vaidyas are depending. So usually in the general practice and in the practices of most of the clinics, these types of assessments are less and we are not able to manage in such type of cases also. So we have to look into these easily available drugs. This is in Sanskrit, it is called as Uttangana. This drug is available in every part and we can use this also. Another is the Jwarakara. So this is one of the pteridophyte, that which is growing on the water. So in Kerala traditions and in the Siddha tradition, this is one of the important drug that can manage the Jwara avasthas. And another place it is mentioned is in the excessive sravas. In Shweta Pradaram and Rekta Pradaram, if any medicines are giving and it is not able to prevent, Rajare is mentioning is Chadushpatri has to be given there. Recently one thesis has completed in Tripuntra Ayurveda College with this drug. In excessive menstrual bleeding, it shows that it is having an excellent result as similar to that of some Ayurveda modern medicines. They compared this study and it's done. So like that, these types of drugs are there. Another important drugs, when the jara is being aggravated and the patient is going to a sannibhada avastha, murcha and vyabadu will be there. On that stage, what the vaidyas will do means, they are preparing some oils or combination of this drug, means red ants egg. Lokhita anda taila is mentioned in Sahasra Yogam, Chikilsa Manjari and Yogamrutam. All these books, this Lokhita anda taila is mentioned. Where it is mentioned? When the fever is become very high and the patient is going to a sannyasa murcha avastha, there it has to be applied on this area, like this area, these areas and the joints. So usually, if you look into the 20 years history of the villages, especially in Kerala, every Vaidya has this term. So when the patient is having severe pain and is bringing back, they will put these tailas on all these places and cover it with a blanket. Within 5 minutes, the patient will start sweating and will bring back that consciousness. So here you can see that body will go into a Shida Avastha. We have to bring back with the Ushnato. So Lohidanda is such a Ushnam that has to be used here. So simply taking this Lohidanda, mixing with breast milk and applying on the head also will bring back such persons to the life. So this is the art of utilizing the nature to the human care. It's there in our books also. So many sannivada avasthas can be managed by these types of drugs. Another is this one, Poonaga. When Vada is aggravated and the person is going to a complete brain blackness or something like that, a Murcha avastha or Sanyasa avastha, and a sannivada Vada has very predominant, Poonaga Thailam is mentioned to bring back the activity that is occurred on the brain and other things. So like that, the Jangama utilization is also one of the important thing. If it is in Navasmara like conditions also, we have certain drugs. The Somavalli is one of the important drug we have to look. The Serapeutia gentia, the Somavalli, one of the source. In the middle photo, you can see that there will be a small kantham is there, a small leaf is there. It is deciduous in nature and it is having a marvelous flower and showing a various character features. These types of drugs, yogas are mentioned. Somavalliyadi Kashayam, Manasamitra Guliga has to be done pavana with this drug. So then it will having that Manasamitra Guliga has having that power. So these drugs has to be incorporated. And along with that, if you see Shula Prasmanam, Vedana Sthapanam, Angamartha Prasmanam, Abhipenam and Bhang. These two drugs are completely excluded from our classics. Actually, these are the drugs that has given a powerful tool to Vaidya for fight against various types of spasmodic pains. Abhipena Asavam is one of the drug which can produce a very nice spasmodic, antispasmodic activity. And like that, Bhangash, these drugs has to be come to our practice, then we can also do some very good thing to the emergency conditions. Another is the one of the drug that is mentioned in our classic is for Gulmaharam and Shulaharam, especially in Kerala classics, that is Kodya Bhujangam. Plenty of references are there for this drug to giving relief to the pain of the abdomen. So especially related to the Nabhi Pradesham and above the Nabhi. So that areas, this is one of the good drug that we have to look, the Kodya Bhujangam. Shulari Kritam, Shulari Vadiga. These are the two yogas that are mentioned in the Sahasra Yoga. The main ingredient is this one. Another is, we know about Kubilu. Kubilu is one of the excellent Vedana Sthavanam and other things. There are various other Kubilu species are there. Strychnus colubriana, Strychnus van Brugge, like that climbing species. Till now we are not exploited by the local peoples. They are using this for Vedana Sthavanam. Especially the Vadarakta related pain and Amavada related pain, they are using these drugs. So you can see the seeds, very similar to that of that one. If you look Ananda Gandham, you can see that utilization of this Valli Kubilu in various pain relieving yogas. So these types of things has to be come to the general practice, then we can also promote an ideal Vedana Sthavanam. Another thing is on the Koshtam itself, this is the Yelavalukam, Heraclium Regis. This is one of the very good for gastric pains. Severe gastritis and pain will be there, just like Jeeragam, Ajamodagam, like this also we can use. And another is the most important thing we have to see is the local peoples or the peoples, those who are in the villages or in the forest, though they don't have any oxytocin or any good management of these things when delivery is conducting. They are simply taking the seeds and the bark of this, making a paste and applying on the suprapubic region and the lower foot, so that the garbha will become very easy. To reduce the labor pain and the labor easiness, they are using this Anamrita coagulus, Kakamani. If you look in Kerala's traditional folklore peoples, or in Andhra or in Tamil Nadu, everywhere we can see the utilization of these things by the peoples. So why can't we can't use these types of drugs? Another is the Varada Gekko. Varada Gekko means a wasp making their nest with mud and their saliva, and that shows that it is one of the best drug for chardi nigrahana. So keeping this mud of this house of this Varada Gekko, then it will be putting in the water, boil it, filter it, and then water is used to drink for chardi nigrahana. Even if the children is not getting any cure by any medicine, Ajare is mentioning to mix this with water and apply on the chest region so that the chardi will prevent it. So one of the important thing is, when we are hearing the mrit we described there before the ganas, on the ganas mrit is mentioned. This is the one type of mrit that has to be used. So the recent findings is astonishing. Some of the valuable amino acids are present in these types of things. And one of the athletes in China is to use this type of things for increasing their stamina in the body. And she is the first athlete got gold medal in marathon. So these amino acids can increase our stamina. So if it is a chardi is also there, we are losing so many things. It can be replaced by these types of things. So actually that reference of this athlete is shared by one of my friend, Dr. Chibi Kuriakos from Ernakulam, a botanist. But once I heard that and linking to this, it shows that a marvelous similarities of these things that utilized by our Vaidyas. And another is Vishakna. This group, you have so many plenty of drugs. This plant, what you are seeing, is the plant utilized by the local peoples. If someone has having an unconscious like feeling, and someone has having a bite by a snake, they will pluck out this leaf, this plant, and the root is smelled through the nostrils. If you simply smell it also, it is having a very peculiar turpentine like penetrating smell. Maybe this turpentine like penetrating smell will help this. In most of the headaches, the people are using this root for smelling so that the headache will lose itself. So another drug is this one. So this is the Appama silicosa or Tortilla silicosa. It's two ways it's occurring. One is having the blue flowers and another is having such flowers. In most of the literatures on the books, the king cobra poison, there will be no antidote. But in the Hortus Malabaricus, a book that is published in 17th century, mentioning about an antidote for this king cobra bite by the Kerala physicians. So they will take the root of this plant, mixed with lemon juice, and it will be used as a nasyam for king cobra poison. So such type of so many naguli gandham, this chakranige, these are one of the marvelous drugs. In Malayalam, there will be a proverb that alpam agathengil visham purathu, means if this drug will be inside, then the poison will be going outside. Another name of this drug is karalayam, means whatever the toxicity that is occurring on the liver, karal means liver, that can be expelled out through this drug. In the tribal medicine, this is one of the important drug that utilized for various types of immunomodulatory properties and for allergic conditions. And another important drug is in the Siddha medicine, in the Siddha sages, they are considering this is the Sandhana Karani that is mentioned in our classical Ramayana. So if you see this drug, this is having so much of specialty, especially it is growing on the rocks. Between the creeps of the rocks, this plant will grow, and it will sustain a severe drought condition also. Whenever there will be a little rain will occur, they will gather the water and will sustain on that particular place. So if you take a leaf and crush it like this, you can make a plaster like thing from that. They are using that for keeping on the wounds so that the bleeding will subside and the wound will heal fast. If you have so much of kandu on the body by some allergic things, especially by ruda visham or something like that, they will rub this on the whole body. so that the kandu will succeed. And another important thing is, this is one of the drug that are using for hydrophobia. So in hydrophobia, they will making a specific formulation. We are not able to get that formulation, and this drug is using in that condition. So the Clinia grandiflora is one of the important drug that has to be looked for Vishaknam, all these conditions in the emergency conditions. So like that, if you look, there are plenty of drugs are there. Only thing is, we have to do a thorough collection of these types of knowledge from various places. So ethnomedical botanical surveys are necessary to find out such type of uses by the local people still existing in the deep forests of India's various parts and the villages. If you document at its this juncture at least, then we can promote or we can make an ideal platform that has started by AVP and Dr. Mail for these types of things to bring back a new pharmacopoeia for emergency medicines. And one more thing is, we have to tell the local authorities and administrators, those who are ruling this, the medico-legal aspects has to be released, relaxed. So it should be made that the vaidyas has to practice by utilizing proper collection of these things from the animals without harming them. And then it has to be utilized in the practice, especially bhang, charas, all these are one of the important thing that is necessary for management. So treatment purpose, at least these types of narcotic drugs has to bring back to Vaidya. Then we have to increase these utilization of these drugs and to promote the opportunities and scopes for the new generation doctors that has to be coming out by updating the proper yogas. So ideal yogas with these types of potent drugs has to be incorporated, and new yoga formulations or updating the yoga formulations is also a necessary in the current situations, along with a thorough continuous researches are also necessary. So a practical demonstrations, if someone is doing, then only we can able to see these things. So yesterday and today, so many eminent great vaidyas are shown their experience, and they shown that much things are they are managing with in the emergency situations. So such a type of practical demonstrations can boost everyone's, because the confidence, courage and skill of a vaidya is very necessary in the managing such type of conditions, and along with proper documentation may get a very nice platform for these types of management, and surely it will helps the whole society in another level. So I took little bit time off, sorry. So thank you one and all, especially the great Krishna Maharaji, Dr. Mayil, and all other doctors of AVP and Sharanya, especially Sharanya complex doctors, all are done so much of work in these aspects. Thanking all of you for giving an opportunity to share some of the information regarding the plants and its usages on this emergency condition. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. We have some questions. Can we share that?
Yeah, sure.
So, sir, one question is that what is the medicine that you leaves that you mentioned for rubbing?
This one, Clinia grandiflora. Clinia grandiflora, Asteraceae family. In Tamil it is called as Maan Kaadu.
Okay, sir. Now, there is a question.
Yeah.
Oxalis corniculata can be used in bleeding disorders similar to Chatushpadi.
Sorry, once more please.
Sir, Oxalis corniculata.
Yes. No. Oxalis corniculata. No. Oxalis corniculata Changeri is a separate drug. We can use it in another place because it's having a predominant of amla rasa. Here, this drug is not having an amla rasa. This drug is not predominant with amla rasa. It's a kashaya dravya pradhana dravya. So it is having a sangrahika.
Okay, sir. Sir, there is a question related to emergency care. That is how to manage convulsions due to metastasis. What are the drugs useful for that?
So that we have to see that conditions. By looking into the doshavali, we can able to say that things. I have no experience in treating such type of conditions, but probably in metastasis it may related to the brain and will resulting in such type of things. I think we can utilize the gorojanadi like things, gorojanadi tablets in the form of rubbing it in the betel leaf, and it can be given along with some shira like things, or it has to be given along with some other dravyas which is having these types of activities, like a sarasudarishtam or something drugs which is having a bala like dravyas like that, also we can try it. But we can't say that it will be curable by that such type of things. It can be manageable. Another thing is better than that is by some pichus or talam on the head. So usually in other types of such type of convulsions, what we are using is we will using the rasnadi churnam or kachuradi churnam, another churna is there. This will be mixed with the shirabala tailam and it will be keeping on the head. That can be a possibility.
Okay, sir, there is one question regarding local bleeding. Which is the best medicine drug used for local bleeding?
That's according to the availability. So the availability, you can select whichever the drugs will be there. There are a large list of drugs are there. Even simply haridra churnam can also prevent the local bleeding. So like that, whatever the availability is there, the peoples are utilizing this. So when we are doing a survey on the Ernakulam district on Thattekkadu bird sanctuary, near to bird sanctuary, this photo was taken there. When this person is telling that, so this person is one of the snake catcher, so he is more related to the forest area. So he has a cut wound, a very large cut wound, and on that time what they have used means simply taken the kambilaga leaf. So kambilaga leaf was taken and crushed that leaf, you will get a green powder. So of the lamina they will get a green powder, and they keeping that green powder on that, and she shown that there will be no scar there. If in such cases at least 5 to 6 stitches are needed. On that condition, they are keeping such type of, so according to the availability of that, we can utilize the drugs. So that is the yukti of the vaidya to select these things. There are so many drugs we have on the surrounding. We have even lead jar has having a very nice activity. Even viparita lead jar, that also has having an activity on this. So like that, you can use different drugs.
Thank you, sir. I think there are some more questions that we don't have time for, so we will conclude the sessions now. Sir, you present dravya guna in a very simple way, explaining it linguistically and logically, and connecting the missing link between clinical conditions to the dravyas and dravyamshas. Thank you, sir, for being so knowledgeable but kind and willing to share it with all of us. We are immensely grateful for you. Thank you, sir. Thank you for being part of the seminar.
Thank you.
Dear delegates, we are moving towards the concluding session of our seminar. Now we have Dr. Mayal Fogley to give you the concluding address. Dr. Mayal Fogley, he is a medical doctor from France, specialized in emergency simulation training and collective disasters. He and his wife came to India to study Ayurveda and ancient sciences in 2016 and has been here since. You might have met him in most of the conferences and seminars of AVP and others. His IU emergency care project started in 2018 with immense support from Dr. Priya Krishnakumarji, Dr. Ramkumarji, and Dr. Indulalji. And he is the brains and the bronze behind this seminar. So Mayal, please welcome you to your own seminar for the address.
Good morning, everyone. I am audible. Hello. Yes, okay. So I will start to share just one or two slides. I cannot share the screen. Allô, vous pouvez m'entendre? Allô, allô, I am audible, but I cannot see myself. Ah, okay. Okay, so now, thank you. I will try again. Hop. Okay, this one. Comment je peux faire? Ok. just to give a little story about why Ayurveda and emergency. So before coming in India and starting to study Ayurveda, I was working in this hospital about 9 years in a little island between Africa and Madagascar, a French island. So there I was half part in the emergency department and half part in the simulation emergency center to give some training. So after this, in 2013, we discovered Ayurveda in Mauritius. And we decided in 2016 with my wife and my son to come to India and to learn Ayurveda deeply. So from this time, we try to follow almost all the seminar from AVP group, and we were suggested by Dr. Indulal and Padmasri Krishna Komarji to give a talk about emergency management. From this, Ayurveda Emergency Care Project starts. This project starts in 2018. So in January 2020, we received the agreement from Ayush Ministry with the logo support. This project is under AVP Research Foundation with the team, Dr. Somit Kumar, Sujit Sir, Dr. Arun, and so many other doctors who help a lot to develop this project. From France, this project is associated with University of Picardy and Simu Santé. Simu Santé is the largest simulation center in Europe, and you can simulate any situation from the life, like in the street, in home, and after in surgery, in ICU, in delivery. So the aim of this project is at the end to have a cooperation with this simulation center and to create trainings for Ayurvedic doctors and students. So Ayurveda community will have Vaidyas with great confidence to face emergency. So from 2016, I tried to observe a little what are the needs to develop emergency management in Ayurveda. So emergency, it can happen everywhere. And the question at the beginning, because I'm from France, not from India. In India, it is mandatory for any doctor to respond to an emergency. And it's not really clear in the text, in the legislation, but most of the people agree it's mandatory for any doctor or Vaidya to respond to an emergency if it happened directly in front of the doctor. So we have to research this, the medical ethics, the law. I was inviting one lawyer to have a talk in this seminar, but with the COVID problem, he has so many work, he's too busy, he cannot. But this is a very important point. The one question most of the time I ask to the practitioner or the student, do you have any emergency training during BAMS? This is not clear. Most of the time, very few. BLS, HCLS, HCLS, PHCLS, all these are protocol from abroad. So I try to get one protocol from India, and there is some, but not well known. Few people use it, and CCLS, BCLS, COLS. They are good protocols, but very not known, unknown. And the question is when we can found a BALS, Basic Ayurveda Life Support. So from this, start really the IU emergency care project. The first part, what we need to face emergency. So this few questions was in my mind. So the reference, text, articles. So in Ayurveda, you have a lot of reference. Now, sometimes it can be good to translate it in the modern science, so it will be validated by everyone. So this we have to work on. Medical emergency network. This, I think, is not in the head of most of the Vedas and Ayurvedic practitioners. I think you have to feel you are one of the actors in the medical emergency rescue chain. With COVID, it was difficult, I know, but this has to be changed. Training and simulation, this we work on now to know how to train and with which basis, and maybe in cooperation with the allopathic centers we work on. Practice and experience. I think in this conference you can see how many experience, how many master handle emergency with a very good expertise. And the last one, and maybe the main one, is the self-confidence. So why an IU emergency training? The question was there. Why we don't just follow allopathic protocols, mainstream, and not much work, just reply. To be aligned with Ayurveda principles and value, because all the students, they learn Ayurveda, and when it's stressful, it's an emergency, they have to switch to physiopathology and allopathic protocols. So for sure, confidence will not be there. So it's needed to have an IU emergency training with the terminology, Ayurveda terminology, and even the way of thinking to decide how emergency can be treated with Ayurveda management and tools. To integrate allopathy when it's needed. You can decide when you need help or you need cooperation. To define what is common knowledge in the protocol and what is really allopathy medicine and management. Because in emergency, most of the time, it's action in the good time or sometimes no action. And the allopathic medicine is really a few parts of the management. To implement the field of Achyayika with Ayurvedic study, practice, and textual reference. So from this, we try to plan a timeline. So the first part was to have a strong basis. The Ayurveda community really needs this. They want to have some training on emergency. And so we start with one survey. The second step is to find the resource person, network, masters, to start the trainings, conference like this. So we are almost in this second step. And the third step will be integrative studies, academic development, national level, and international cooperation to have a strong response and like cohesion. So no one can just say, oh, this, what is it? It's not scientific. No, no. We need to build every wall to be very strong. So the first step was we did a test study on two workshops with 100, almost 120 students and practitioners. And now one survey is online. And thank you, with this conference, a lot of people answer more in 2 weeks, more than 500 answers. So the goal is to go beyond 1,000 to have a strong study and to publish this in a well-known journal. So the objective of this survey, it was to identify the practitioner and the student demand to face emergency, what you need. The first look on competencies, confidence, experience, previous emergency training, and the motivation. This is the only survey. So I think in the group everyone addressed this. The second step is to create an integrative team of experts from Ayurveda and from allopathy. So from Ayurveda, we have a very, very good team, and you can see every lecture is very interesting. To start from Indian and international references, to train the student and the practitioner with active pedagogy and simulation. If there is some gurukulam, can be best, but we have to look at this. And to research on each subject, if every practitioner can write one case report this year, maybe 50 or 100 case report on emergency management with Ayurveda, this can be a very strong basis for scientific validation. The third step will be to revive Acharika Chikitsa. It was there. Every master told me it was there. Their master were practicing Acharika Chikitsa. Keep Ayurveda principle and classical references, implement them with other medical skills, diagnostic tools, technology, but keep emergency as a part of Ayurveda. Develop active pedagogy. This is very important because Gurukulam is no more there. So we need to really practice and live the theoretical information to transform this in real knowledge. The final goal is to build a strong response in the field of emergency. Each Ayurveda practitioner should be a real actor of the emergency and rescue chain in India. And next can be integrative research in emergency department, ICU. And each time we have to know well the limitation of each medical system to start an intelligent cooperation or integration. For this project, we design 5 departments. First one is the documentation to compile all the data and the knowledge and the practice of traditional Vedya, textual reference. The second one can be publication to make, maybe to write a book on this or some article to collect all the case reports and to help the practitioner to publish case reports and to slowly grow this scientific data. The third one is IU emergency unit, integrative management. This this we have started very recently in AVP Ramathapuram in Coimbatore and Patanjalipuri in near here, Navakarai Ashwad Hospital, and in Vidyagrama. So we start to find a place to create an emergency room, emergency unit, and to know what we need inside. Ayurvedic drug and allopathic support if needed, and the contact, transport, and to start the management in each hospital, and if needed, to have a good link, good relation, and to ask for cooperation. The third one, it's a simulation lab, Acharika Vidyalaya, so training center. So this we have started to give a few training and to research what can be the best formula to train Ayurvedic doctor. And the fifth one, the last one, is international cooperation to give some sense to this project and to see if we can have some expert from there and maybe financial support. This concept needs support. Official recognition. So this starts in January. Thanks a lot for Ayush Ministry to recognize this project. Resource person. So we have a lot now with this conference, and I hope more and more from different states to have a unicity in this country. Logistic and material, legal support, financial support, to little by little create bridge with allopathy doctor. And this, every one of us can do this. Maybe in your family you have allopathic doctor, maybe some friend allopathic doctor, or you have to start talking with them and to see where we can create bridge and work together. International cooperation, so this, I hope soon we will start this. And the support from all of you to believe this can be possible. It's one part of your medical practice. Are you ready for this? Thank you very much and to be there. And thanks for all the lecturer and the team of AVPRF and Ashiwat in Navakarai. Very great to work with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Mayal. With this, we are coming to an end of the first leg of seminar on emergency and critical care in Ayurveda, co-organized by Ayurvedic Pharmacy Research Foundation and Ashirvad Health and Education Trust, supported by Ministry of Ayush and IPGTRA. Hope you all enjoyed, learned, inspired, and benefited from our program and all the great masters that we hosted. The second leg of the seminar will continue next weekend, Saturday and Sunday. Brochure for the next weekend will be released on WhatsApp groups. We thank you all for all the support, patience, and kindness. See you next week. Good night.